It is almost time. The past few hours passing like the lifetime that led them here. The tunnel smells like adrenaline and sweat. The crowd outside roars in their ears like a jet engine. Their pulses racing. Nothing matters right now but ending the wait. The basest human instincts colliding. Pain and love and fear and desire. Can you feel it? The noise is coming down, cleared for takeoff. A wall of sound waiting for the first chord. The building is revving, lurching, wild and limitless. It is time. Here we go.
And good evening, everybody. Joe Tessitore with you as I welcome you to the College Football Playoff National Championship here. Our version of the MegaCast. It is the Monday Night Football Film Room. You know the guys who are on Mondays with me in the NFL, Booger McFarland and Jason Witten. And then we said we need to rent ourselves a draft expert. So please say hello to Mr. Todd McShay.
I'm listen, goods. Yeah.
Glad to have you, man.
Happy to be here.
You're going to merge both worlds here for us,
McShay. I'm excited to hear you talk for 4 hours.
I'm going to limit that. It's going to be all about the three of you guys. But we're going to have some fun here. We're going to be relaxed. We're going to break things down. I mean, this is basically every week of being on the road with you guys. You're just hearing XO nonstop. Yeah. And it's going to be free form in here. Obviously a fascinating matchup. This is the fourth time that Bama and Clemson have met in the college football playoff, the third time they're doing so for a national championship, both 14-0, both with dominating defensive lines, both with young quarterbacks who are so impressive. But I want to start up front with you, Boog, and your expertise, because there is a guy in the middle of that defensive line for Alabama who is sensational.
Yeah, number 92, Quinnen Williams, and he kind of came out of nowhere. If you go back to last year, people really didn't understand who this guy was. But right now, when you see him up front, he's a game wrecker. He's a guy that you must account for. Take a look at him here in a one-on-one situation. If you put him one-on-one, he can dominate and get to your quarterback. That's the sign of a great defensive lineman. Can you win your one-on-one matchup? But if you want to be special, not only do you have to beat the one-on-one, when they double-team you, the guard, here comes the back, you got to split the double-team and get to the quarterback. And if you're good enough to beat the single, and if you're good enough to beat the double, then you know what some teams would do? They say, oh, hell, let's put three guys on you. And now, if you can beat three, the guys that can do that test, they're truly special. I think he's a special player. He's a late bloomer that came out of nowhere. And he's going to be a factor tonight. If I'm Dabo Swinney and I'm Clemson and Trevor Lawrence, I know where 92 is at all times. I'm going to double team him. I'm going to make sure he doesn't wreck my game plan.
Yeah, Trevor Lawrence, the freshman quarterback. We were just down on the field. We literally came up here 5 minutes ago.
Got to see sunshine?
Yeah, you saw sunshine because that hair is something now. We'll talk about that throughout the night.
I'm going to implement a rule right now. I'm not calling him Trevor Lawrence. I'm calling him Sunshine the rest of the night.
You go for it.
Just FYI.
I'm plenty good with that. But you turn to me, you go, oh, he can spin it now. I mean, this kid can spin it now.
I was blown away. I mean, think about this. A year ago, he's playing high school football. And I'm with you, Boog. I wasn't crazy about the hair. But when he throws for 400 tonight, you're going to call him Trevor Lawrence. And he's going to be the number one draft pick before long. What does he do that's so special is he sees coverage, right? What Nick Saban's going to try to do is disrupt pocket passers. Nick dominates them, but he sees it. It's two-man. It's actually an invert where the corner's going to drop back and play that two-high shell. He sees it pre-snap. He knows exactly where he wants to go with the ball. He's 6'6". He can see over the line. He wants to be a pocket passer. Man coverage underneath. He can drop it in there. But tonight, what I look for him to do, he's going to have to get outside the pocket. He's going to have to use the legs. Watch the tape of Kyle Murray. Watch what he did, getting outside the pocket. And then manipulate with your eyes. Pull the corner up and then hit the touchdown pass. They're not going to go on 15, 16 play drives. Yeah. That's not the formula for this Clemson football team. He's going to have to have big plays. Yeah. He's going to have to do it outside the pocket.
I'm fascinated to see, you know, how he is on the big stage now, because things get different when you get to this point.
And they're
going to
come after him, too.
Oh, there's no doubt about it. Right? So pass pro is going to be critical for Alabama. Yeah. Take us through Alabama offensively a little bit.
Well, I think one thing you're going to see a lot out of them is going to be the RPO game, the run-pass option. And they love to do it because –
because two was so comfortable in it. It came from a system in high school where they did it, and that's the biggest difference between the offense a year ago and today. Now, here against zone, you're going to see they're going to motion the H-back, figure out its zone coverage, and RPOs are zone killers. You see the inside handoff at the mesh. He's reading. He sees the two linebackers coming in, and now you know, all right, I'm going to have a spot in this cover three zone. Now, the free safety does a good job jumping it. His angle's not great. That's the problem. And then the throw right on time, right where it needs to be. I think we're going to see a lot of that tonight, especially if Clemson's trying to go zone coverage in order to limit him as a runner. And that RPO game was killer against Oklahoma, and it could be a big problem for Clemson tonight.
You know, I completely agree with you on that. I think the one thing to watch for early on, take away the slant routes. Make Tua throw the football over the top.
We'll see. We're going to take a quick break and come back. Are you hungry? Do we need to order food?
I got cashews, but if anybody has
cashews, I'm so sick of eating cashews on the road with you Monday night.
Yeah, I like cashews.
We go through like literally, I'm not exaggerating.
It's a light snack.
40 pounds of cashews consumed on the Monday Night Football crew this year. I mean, it is out of control. It's not an exaggeration. Gee. That's not a big concern as we welcome everybody back here to the Monday Night Football Film Room, part of the mega cast of the College Football Playoff National Championship. Bama, and you need a pen?
Yeah, I think this is mine you took from the Monday Night Football.
Yours. Go ahead. It's back to you now. Bama and Clemson, they have won 11 of the last 12 college football playoff games, and here they go again. It is time for our national anthem. Air Force Base, California. Please welcome multi-platinum-selling pop artist Andy Grammer.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free? And the
magnificent way to start the night as we celebrate our country. Beautiful flyover here in Santa Clara. We are just off to the side, seven floors above field level here. Can peek out the side window here and get a sense of what's going on inside. When we were down on the field, and Witt, I want to ask you this. You had a conversation with Dabo Swinney. This guy was as calm and cool as could be prior to playing for a national title.
I've been around a lot of coaches in big games. I've never seen a coach that relaxed.
Totally chill.
You know, he's hanging out. He visits, like, it got to that point where I'm like, all right, coach, I'm going to let you go. You know what I mean? Like,
exactly.
I know, right. He just kept talking. He kept going and going. He was talking about, you know, being in the Cotton Bowl last week, my career, what his expectations were for tonight's game. It was amazing to see him with his family, his wife, all smiles. Hey, the hay's in the barn is what he said. I think he feels pretty confident in his team.
We did the media day the other day, covered both teams. Alabama comes in, and it is like, you know, it's like watching the armed forces.
Right,
you know?
Exactly.
Nick says nothing.
Full battalion.
Yeah. Yes.
Right, yeah.
Security guards everywhere. Right, yeah. It's so serious. And then they leave, and it's like, we got nothing out of it. Not a thing. He didn't say anything. Clemson comes roaring in. Dabo's talking to everyone. Yeah. He's going on for like 10 minutes with his first answer, just talking about how he saw tumbleweed for the first time in his life when he landed. He saw Joey Chestnut and went nuts.
Joey Chestnut, the competitive eater?
Yeah, he was there.
Joey Chestnut was at the media.
He was at the media.
Another Joey Chestnut?
Was Joey Chestnut given a media credential?
Joey Chestnut, I think, was asked to come, and he was showing off his belt.
I know about the mustard belt, but this country never ceases to amaze me as to what we will claim celebrity and/or talent.
But he stopped the whole press conference like, Joey Chestnut, I watch you every July.
Nathan, you had a visit with Nick just about 15 minutes ago.
Yeah, and I think it was some insight. Nick was having some fun. He's like, hey, can you give me just two more pass rushes? just two, because I think he understands that tonight he's going to have to get after Trevor Lawrence. Yes. And I think something early on to watch for, guys, is when Clemson has the football and Trevor Lawrence is in the pocket, where the pressure comes from. I think it's coming right up the gut.
True.
A-gap.
Yep.
I think they're bringing A-gap pressure, and to me, that's going to be the story of this game. Can Trevor Lawrence and the Clemson offensive line, can they handle the A-gap pressure? Because if you go back and you watch last year's game, Kelly Bryant, they had guys open. Yeah. He just wouldn't throw the football. Man. He couldn't get the ball down.
He was getting bulldozed.
And you got Quinnen in the middle, too.
Yeah.
So correct. If you double on him, there's going to be open.
Right. But think about, like, in NFL, right? Our world is Bill Belichick. When you play against him in the playoffs, he takes away the best thing that you do.
Yep.
And forces you to play left-handed.
Yep.
So for Lawrence, it's force him outside the pocket. Yep. You can't allow the 6'6", Sunshine, and the pretty boy standing there, because he'll pick you apart. I mean, he's shown that he can do that.
Yeah.
Right? With these weapons, Ross and Higgins, I was blown away looking at these guys. Yeah. You know? I mean, they're 6'4", they're 210, they can run. So he's going to force them. He's going to try to take it away. That's what Nick Saban does best. Take away what you do and then force him to play.
The Ross kid was awesome now. I mean, he looks awesome. Number eight, the wide receiver for Clemson.
True freshman.
By the way, from Alabama.
He had six
from the state of Alabama.
148 yards, two touchdowns against Notre Dame.
Yes.
Because you start covering all these other guys.
Got a salty defense.
Yeah.
Well, and against this Alabama defense, think about it. No longer do you have the veteran guys. Savion Smith, JUCO transfer corner.
Yep.
Freshman, Patrick Surtain. When's the last time we seen Nick start a JUCO transfer first year and a first-year freshman at cornerback? That lets you know that the talent level on the back end isn't what it used to be back there with some of the guys that's gone to the NFL. So as we look at where does Clemson have an advantage in this game? Maybe not on the sideline, but I think from a cornerback receiver standpoint, I may lean toward the Tigers on that.
Yeah, can we just look at the backside of Christian Wilkins for a moment here? I mean, how girthy. By the way, when you talk about generational. Now, listen, I know there's a difference once they get turned over to McShay and then they come and play on our air. There's a difference, but generationally, he's one of the great college football players. You think about his career.
He plays fullback. They get him involved he plays all special team units, every single one. And he's the first guy down. If you notice when they score a touchdown on offense, he's the first guy down there. His energy.
I'm gonna give you a scouting tip, McShay.
Okay.
Look at his ankles.
Sure.
Small ankles.
Yep.
Anytime you see a guy with small ankles, I don't care how big his trunk.
I've never heard that before. But
look at his ankles. If his ankles are small, he's a great athlete.
Oh, hey guys, look who's out there.
Well, at least he showed up here. He didn't show up.
Hey, whoa.
He didn't show up on Saturday.
Whoa.
At least he showed up here.
Yeah, but hey, when we sat with Watson the other day. So we're sitting with Deshaun Watson McShay before the wild card game the other day. I said, what do you got for prediction? He said, he likes his team by nearly two touchdowns. He said 10 to 14
points. What's he going
to
say, Bama?
He said, he was so confident. He was so confident saying they're going to tear him up with the pass. Here's the coin toss. Let's listen in.
Captains, congratulations on your successful seasons and achieving this goal of playing in the national championship game. This is our special coin that we'll be using today. Heads will be the national championship logo. The tails will be Levi's Stadium. Clemson, you've been chosen to call the flip, heads or tails. He calls heads, I'll let it land on the ground. Tails, Alabama, you win the toss. You want to defer to the second half. Alabama wins the toss, defers to the second half. You want to receive. Where would you like to kick from? Okay, swing around here, please. Start the game. Clemson will receive.
young kids in a spot like this, but these guys got some experience in these bigger spots, huh?
Yeah.
Nick Saban going for history tonight, trying to win his 7th national championship.
Tied with Bear right now.
He's tied with Bear Bryant right now with 6. Of course, one of those at LSU, 5 at Alabama.
But I think if he wins this one tonight,
oh, please.
I mean, yeah. Greatest college coach ever. He may already be there.
Yeah,
but I think if he wins this one tonight.
Well, you got to realize Bear did his in, what, 25 years? Nick has done his in 12.
Well, plus the roster management back then.
Exactly. Yeah.
You're putting away 140 players on a team, and everybody else in the country wasn't grabbing good players. Right. Now so, talent spread out throughout the country.
You go to the NFL, you still remember your college roots.
Yeah.
You still got it up here.
Yeah.
I'm impressed.
Mm. Mm. Welcome back home, huh?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, so nice to be back with you, Mitch A, by the way.
I know. I missed you, man.
Oh, I missed you this year. You're going to be so sick of us before this NFL draft prep.
No question.
The three of us knocking on your door to get ready for the NFL draft coverage.
You three must be sick of each other.
No. Can't get enough. Christian Wilkins readying for his final college game.
Alabama won the toss, deferred. They want to go on defense first. Typical defensive coach. I think we all get that.
Even though the offense is driving the ship.
Yeah, but that's not how Nick thinks, though. I mean, he's always going to think about his defense.
Is there anything tone-setting that you look for early?
I think you try to run the football. I mean, all the talk about the quarterback. I look for, you know, the RPOs and all the different stuff. Look for some dives. Hit them in the mouth, right? When you get in big games, it gets back to the fundamental.
Yeah, you're bringing back
little
the bases,
things,
yeah.
Right? You can't turn the ball over. You got to play well in special teams. Look at the playoffs there, you know, just the last week.
That's true.
And don't forget, everyone, you know, so deep Clemson is on defense.
Why do you fair catch it?
No, that's a new rule. It's a new rule.
Yeah,
they, you know, cleaning everything up here.
Yeah.
I won't even get 25. Into it. You don't want my opinion on that too early now.
No,
you
no.
Don't,
yeah.
Nobody needs that.
Sunshine!
There he is, Boog.
Sunshine!
At some point, he's going to cut his hair, and he's going to be like, you know what, now I'm all grown up and mature, but right now, Sunshine better have a night tonight, boys.
By the way, I've got the remote. What's the over-under on how long it takes you guys to steal it out of my hand, huh?
Oh, please. Start booking that right
let
now.
Let you coordinate that.
Let's see what we get early on here.
Quick screen up top.
Is that what you see? Hunter Renfro's been in college. Oh, it batted it right back down in space at Jennings. Yeah.
Yeah, I get to do this all night.
Go for it. Let me see. Like,
you know, what's taking you so long, Todd?
Yeah, a little double stack up top, trying to run.
Just the old space,
too.
He's got the quick read.
Punch him in the chest.
Back.
See the corner.
Well, in a situation like that, the tackle's got to get he's got to get Anthony's arms down.
Yeah. How about the pursuit?
I don't know that I want to run sideline to sideline versus this group.
No, they're going to beat you to the line.
I don't know if I want to run up the middle either.
Well, I think we all realize that if they're going to win this game tonight, they're not going to do it by being the Nebraska Cornhuskers under
Tom
Osborne.
Right. Right. Exactly.
Like, this is not going to be 3 yards in a cloud of dust.
They do have to find a way to get DTN going on.
Well, you know how they stack? They do these stacks
because
it doesn't allow them to be able to press them. I mean, everything Nick does is physical at the line of scrimmage.
Right. Sertan and Savion out there, cornerback.
You got him.
Oh, he fell down.
Ooh, that is a...
Well, it's a 3-and-out to start the game.
And that ball came out hot.
And notice what they had, though. The 6'2 Sertan on Hunter Renfro.
Right.
Hunter Renfro's the third down guy. I think anytime you watch Clemson, they're going to look for Hunter Renfro. But look at the corner.
5'10 is Renfro.
Right.
Yeah.
5'10 on a great day.
Yeah, watch him at the top of the route, Renfro, okay? Third play. He slips. See how many times we say this tonight at the top when he tries to come out of it.
Well, that and it's a physical corner.
Yeah, it is a physical corner.
Yeah. You probably played against his dad, huh? Patrick Sertan, Miami.
Well, are you trying to say something about
Sertan
being old?
He is older. He's not young now. There's a reason he's not playing.
What are you talking about?
I'm starting to get depressed. Guys that I've scouted in my career. Now
you're going through the next generation now? You scouted dads of players who now you're scouting?
Starting to happen.
Wow, Mache. What'd you think of Tua last week?
Brilliant.
Was he?
Absolutely.
And coming off the injury.
Not knowing if he was going to be 100%.
Yeah.
What was he? He threw more touchdown passes than any completion.
Yeah.
Sick.
He threw slants all day. Like, I mean, if Clemson doesn't take away the slant tonight, I'd be shocked.
Yeah. That was the RPO. They worked that all day long.
Come out of zone coverage and play some more man-to-man, though.
RPO.
There it is.
What's the read there? What's he reading?
He's just got the slant flat on the backside. For them, they're reading that backside back who rushes off the edge.
Yeah, he's supposed to take the flat.
As soon as he takes that step in, he knows he's thrown.
Right.
Yeah.
Cornerback's carrying. He come off late.
I like this Harris kid in the backfield.
I love this laser look.
Go for it.
Oh, there we go.
Now you know what's going to steal it out of your hand.
He got blitz.
Oh, wow.
No, it's working.
Good ball.
That's Tua, though, man. Even when you don't block him up front, he gets the ball out and completes it, right?
I mean, bringing the blitz up the A-gap, doesn't get touched. Ball still, right, look how big that is. Yeah, look at 34 coming right up the A-gap there.
Harrison's got to pick it up.
Oh, there we go. Now we're getting good at this thing.
Oh, yeah.
Switch it to Sky. I mean, like a producer in here.
Joseph hesitates. He's got to go. Yeah, let's go. I mean, Harris misses the block.
I like your aggression there with the quicker. Other side.
Oh, it's a touchdown.
What do we got here? Pick that, six.
That's a touchdown.
Oh, man.
Wow.
So we saw
That's Terrell, A.J. Terrell.
We saw this in the Houston game, right? They're going to play cover two off of this and pick it up. So the corner's going to come off of it. They're running the flat, and he sees it. Look at it right away. He comes off the corner. So he's got the inside slot receiver running to the flat. He thinks he's got him beat, but watch the corner up top come off of it.
Okay.
So they're going to blitz.
Yep.
And then the outside corner just baits it. He baits him into the throw. He thinks he's got it.
It's A.J. Terrell playing out.
Simmons came off the corner. So Tua's thinking, blitz, I'm going to throw hot. I get it.
Yeah. Let's see what he's seeing.
Yeah, so just take a look at it. The Simmons comes off. Tua's thinking, okay, throw the hot.
Yep, throw the hot. There we go. Nope, that's programmed. Sky. Yep, we'll get it.
You like that look?
Nope.
What do you want? Which look are you looking for?
I was trying to get the sky, but I think I ruined it.
Yeah, go back to it again. Let me take us through that again.
Everybody wants to get the ball out in a hurry to start the game. Clemson, you got to give them credit to play that and bait them into those throws to throw the flat and the corners playing off. It's hard. We saw Deshaun Watson do it in the
playoff game. Exactly, yeah.
When you're playing quick game, the ball's coming out.
Brent Venables, man.
Yeah.
Is this it, McShay?
Yeah, this is
it. Yeah, this is it.
So who do you want to watch? You want to watch that inside corner, right?
Let's go back down to the field with Janelle Klein. I'll go back to all 22.
There you go.
The inside corner's coming.
Yep.
You got number 11, Isaiah Simmons. That's 11. Isaiah Simmons there.
So he thinks it's man-to-man right away.
Right.
So he thinks he's going to be able to throw this little flat route to his slot receiver.
Boy, he timed it, too. He didn't go too early. Right on the snap.
And he misses the throw.
Yes, he throws it inside.
Yeah, throw was behind.
He throws it inside and behind.
Here you can see from his vantage point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a great play by number 8, Terrell, though. Because
it is.
Just making a play, because that wasn't his guy.
No, he came off his
guy. By the way, did the slot corner get just a little piece of that ball as he came in rushing? Go back to that. Does he get just a little piece of the ball?
Yeah, maybe a hair.
Right there.
Ooh.
You see that? Watch the back. Watch the spiral of the ball. Watch the white on the ball. You see that?
You might be right.
Wow. Talk about a momentum shifter though, early on. All
right. That's what it's all about, right?
That's on me, though. Look at Tua.
Tua.
He's out. It's on me. It's on me.
Yeah, I know it's
a mistake.
I know it's on you. Who else is it on? You threw it.
Yeah.
Nobody else threw it, but you.
By the way. The worst teammate to come over to the bench to
it's on me.
I like knowing the quarterback does that. I like when the quarterback comes over, lets everybody know.
Right.
Because everybody's looking. They don't know, right? Yeah. And most quarterbacks just go sit down, or we'll talk about it tomorrow. I like the fact that he comes over. Hey, that one's on me.
Yeah.
You know?
I do too. I knew it was on you when you threw it.
If you didn't say it, I was going to tell you.
Exactly. Like, what are we? Now, here's the thing about Saban. In years past, when the passing game gets in trouble, what does he go to?
Come and pound it out.
He turns around and starts pounding it out. Yep. Does he
can't
do that?
Help himself.
He exactly. But, but does he do that, or does he let the kid keep throwing the ball?
I think with this kid, he's going to let him throw.
Interesting.
And even the way Tua reacts there gives you confidence that you can, right? There's a maturity.
Yeah,
even at a young age, there's a maturity about him.
He can handle this.
Uh-huh.
He can handle this.
Well, hey,
I think both these quarterbacks.
A year ago tonight, look what the kid handled.
Yeah.
But think about this. 47 points a game.
Yeah.
That's what this offense is scoring.
Yeah.
You've got to trust him. I mean, you know, you've had a full year with him. got to believe that he can score points and bounce back from it.
41 touchdowns against 4 interceptions. That's number 5 right there.
Wow.
They were serious about no commercials, huh?
Oh, I got no problem with that. I got no problem with that.
Go to break.
I'm sitting here racing off on Monday Night Football with like 3 seconds to spare. Please.
It's ridiculous.
Oh, I love it.
All fly.
Yeah.
Do we have any more of these waters? My favorite Italian sparkling waters. Are they over there?
Okay. Am I wired up or can I?
You like the roll on the kickoffs now? I forgot about that.
Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, it's okay.
Everything's going to have to run it out.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, bud. Appreciate that.
They don't kick it in the end zone.
Right. Some
yeah,
point.
Thank you.
We're not going to have kickoffs.
Sure, that's here right, you go. You know?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Dude,
please, I got scholarships to worry about.
Here's the thing on this, though. I think six was blocky. I think it was a call pick. If you watch number 6 there, I think he's going to block. It's not like he's running a slant and a flat.
Okay.
I think he's going to block.
So you think the inside receiver
was running the flat,
yeah,
and the outside, number 6 there, Smith,
yeah,
was going to block. It's old pick route. Aaron Rodgers runs it all the time.
All right, back to business.
There we go.
Just as you said.
First play?
Inside run.
Right. That's what Nick does, though, because Nick understands that he's got 5 stars everywhere on the offensive line, and he's got a running back that he really trusts in Damien Harris. And I think that when all hell breaks loose, he's going to run the football to settle his team down.
Yeah, no Dexter Lawrence would be interesting if they can exploit that. Although it's a nice luxury having a guy.
Huggins is pretty good.
Huggins is pretty good. He's going to be a day 3 draft pick, and that's your 5th defensive lineman.
Good balance.
But that's, you know, right up the middle there.
To go back to it, yep, the alternate 2. 6-man box, right? 4 down linemen, 2 backers. You got to run it all the time. And you got 6 for 6.
It's basically a 2-high look.
Yeah.
Because that safety that's creeped down, you don't really count him in the box.
So it's just the inside zone with 6-on-6. They got to feel pretty confident. Safety's trying to get down late. See, that's where their 7th guy's going to come. He's really like the middle linebacker.
Yeah, and then he misses the tackle.
Yeah, but it's like that. It's all on him then at that point.
Yeah, but you got to make that. If you're going to come down that, you got to make that tackle, though.
Yeah, their safeties are elite.
How so? Tua's taking a shot here.
And he's got him.
Yeah. I love Judy. Look at this kid, Judy. Look at how quick that was.
He is so accurate.
Is he? He's such a catchable deep ball, too.
Wow.
That didn't take long.
No.
Hey, how was that response?
The maturity of these young quarterbacks blows me away. I throw a pick, 6. I come back. I'm just going to drop a 50-yard bomb down there on him. You know? Double move, too.
Oh, there, double move on the go. Wow.
I got a lot of work to do here tonight.
Yeah, you're going to see this move.
He double moved.
Wait, take us through this one, will you?
Yeah, so watch him. He's going to go post and then go. And the safety's trying to drive on it. All that space, they're playing off coverage.
What did I just say?
Look at the throw.
Safeties are a weak spot.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And the speed of Alabama, the wide receiver, that's different. There's a Calvin Ridley. There's one guy a year. They've got 4 or 5 of them that can legit run and play.
Who's Judy remind you of in terms of a prospect?
Oh, jeez.
Who in the Alabama, among the Alabama guys on
probably,
the spectrum?
Probably Ridley because
he's Ridley-ish.
Yeah, because of speed. And he's not Jones.
Well, no, he's not Julio. No, he's not that freak show.
He can run and he can run. The thing with Ridley and with Judy, they came out of high school ready to run routes. They know what they're doing.
Hey, does anybody have Brent Venable's cell phone number? Because I'm going to call him now. Right. And if he thinks that Tanner Muse can line up from 15 yards off and play Jerry Judy, I don't care what move he does. He has no chance.
That's the safety 19.
Yeah, I mean, he has no chance in there.
What he's doing, though, is he's bringing up that Kendall Joseph, and he's blitzing him to make it a 5-on-5.
34?
Yeah, and they're not.
The backer?
Yeah, it's 2 times in a row that we've seen that. Guess what? It doesn't matter. Mm. That ball's coming out.
Yeah.
I'm going back to it. I want to see this guy. What else do we have to do, right?
Yeah, run it back. Bring it back. You got to move that thing a little faster, though.
I know. I mean, quicker. The coach copy stuff, you can just go play with play.
Hey, pass the cashews over there, man.
You got those cashews?
Yeah, I mean, this is a game.
Would it take 3 minutes?
Yeah, we're watching game action. Come on. I don't need those, but I do need some.
All right, I'm going to bring it over to Sky. Just want to see what he sees.
Good pickup, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was.
I mean, good enough.
But that's Jacobs. See, that's not Harris.
Yeah.
Jacobs, you like Jacobs may be better in pass pro.
Hey, listen, Jacobs is going to be a good pro back.
He is. And Damien Harris is going to be.
I like Damien Harris. He's reliable. You know, Jacobs was ridiculously under-recruited.
I know.
He was a Tulsa kid playing. He was playing Wildcat quarterback out of a small high school in Tulsa. He was getting nothing looks. I mean, he was like, you know, like Wichita, like that kind of stuff. Late in the game, Mizzou comes in. And I think Nick came in the week of signing day.
He's still, look, I'm telling you.
Yeah. Look at that.
He's coming, and Tua doesn't even flinch.
He steps right into it.
Yeah, right into it.
I mean, but 19 has no chance, though. Like, if you're Brent Venables, you cannot allow that to happen.
That's what Tanner Muse is. He's 6'1", 230-pound strong safety that really is just a college linebacker back in safety.
Right.
You know, against his speed, no space. Chance. You can't against play him off like that because he's
got to press.
You got to be aggressive with these guys and say that Tua has to be dead accurate right. if they're going to beat you.
Right.
You know, I mean, that's how it's going to have to play.
Judy's so good.
Fifth touchdown catch, 50-plus yards.
Come on. He's a sophomore.
True sophomore. Best
He's a true
country.
Sophomore. Yeah. Oh, yeah. He's got 550.
He won the Blitnikoff, right?
Yeah.
Really smooth, isn't he, Whip?
He is smooth. Long stride. You know, the route runners, the guys that can just get that track speed and then at the top get in and out of it.
Lawrence again.
That three and out was ugly.
Three and out. And
yeah. three. It's that been a long time like since that three and out, but yeah. not in his mind.
And, you know, yeah. Tua's got two touchdowns.
Wait a minute. Hold on a second now.
I mean, he does. He's got two of them. Seriously. He's got two. He's got one for Clemson. He's got one for Alabama. So if I'm Trevor Lawrence, it's time to get on the board.
That's a fact.
I mean, I'm just being honest with you. He's got two.
Oh. Chase Bryce.
But notice, Clemson's going back to the same formation. Double stacks, yep. right on top of each other, so as we talked about, so guys can't get jammed. Five in the box for Bama, they pull it.
Oh, wow. Hey, you know what? Trying to make it easy for his first completion, just give him some confidence.
He's a little,
still doesn't
he's a worked
it.
Up.
He's got, what do we say? A true freshman, let's see how he is on the bigger stage.
Yeah. He's shown.
You're just trying to get him into something right there, right?
I mean,
just get him a pitch and catch.
This is the easiest throw you'll ever.
Okay, well, it's an incompletion over his head.
I mean, it's like,
yep.
I mean, that wasn't even close, though.
You're trying to settle him down. There's his first completion of the night.
Let's watch it.
It's a flag down.
It's just going to be interesting to see how Dabo uses Sunshine tonight. Because they made the move from Kelly Bryant midseason for this night.
Tripping.
Right.
Like, this offense. Was the,
oh, there's no question.
This was the game that they made that move for.
Right.
So if you make that move for this night, you got to let him throw it tonight.
What was
yeah,
the call?
They will.
What was the call?
Let's see. It's on 74. It's on tripping on the left tackle. Oh, yeah, I mean, that's blatant on the left guard, excuse me.
Yeah, I mean, Quinnen Williams was going to get there if he didn't trip.
Yeah, that's just that's John Simpson, the left guard.
Second and 22.
Let's go watch.
Kelly Bryant, this will be just a handoff. Let's see what he does with Sunshine.
That's free access right there.
Yeah.
You're going to play that far off. And they're in a bracket.
Right. They're playing in and out coverage.
Yeah.
Linebacker's got inside. Corner got the outside there.
Right.
But it's all about the run fake. Run fake holds that inside backer just a little bit so yep. that he can throw.
Yeah, all that room. And the backer's not going to get over there
yeah.
to make that play.
But you know what? Second and 22.
Yeah, but now
so, give him that.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, now you're sitting there with third and 14.
Yeah, no question.
You pin back your ears. And Mac Wilson's sitting up there in the A-gap already.
Back and stack.
Got protection.
He's got it. He's
got protection.
Him.
Boy, that was big. That's T. Higgins.
What's Maiden doing, though? The safety. I mean, he just runs right. He splits him. I mean, he just goes vertical. He just runs straight.
Yeah, but he's sitting up.
Maiden doesn't even drop,
which
though.
Which number was that? In. What safety is that?
Maiden, 14? 14, right?
No, 14 is Thompson.
Thompson.
Yeah, 21 is Maiden.
Yeah, 14.
He's just sitting there.
That's Thompson.
Yeah. Deontay.
That was what they need. They didn't need that. But they protected him.
I mean, what are they wind up doing? Getting to the edge. Got him. Oh, they got something. That's a touchdown.
That's a great effort. Wow. Break that tackle.
Wow.
Ty, can we go back, to,
the go
big
back
catch?
To the big pass? Yep.
Yeah.
Let's see how it plays out.
Yeah, the quarterback just opens up. He's expecting inside help.
Where's he going to get it from? The safety just doesn't – he doesn't come – this safety –
Here's my thing, though. It's quarters coverage.
Yep.
Right? So he should be carrying number two. So really the corner up top, number four, is that?
Yep.
That is
it?
Savion Smith.
He should carry number one, which is – that route. So when we're getting on the safety, yeah,
the safety's not moving
back.
Anywhere.
He doesn't move, but the corner's got to carry. He's got number one vertical in quarters coverage.
He's got to stay with him the whole way.
He's got to carry.
Yeah. So more to blame on the corner from the get-go.
I think so, yeah. But the safety, he's got to have his eyes up, knowing, like, hey, deep is the deepest. Where's the deepest is the deepest?
Yeah. And this is a touchdown run.
Well, this is a great play by Etienne.
Zone read.
He's got speed, man.
He does.
Watch 49.
Yeah. Bugs.
DN.
Bugs.
Watch him, though. He doesn't even move. I mean, let Lawrence run it. You know, I guess he's taking away the quarterback.
Yeah, but what's the threat? Right,
but I'd let Lawrence tuck it and run it.
Yeah, that's the thing.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, so what he's saying is tell 49, just take the bat.
Yeah,
right, exactly.
It's wide.
Let Lawrence keep.
Right. It's not the old school dive and then keep quarterback keep on
that. At that point, he's not good.
It's the opposite of that.
He's not going to track down ETN.
But, you know, the way teams have always attacked Alabama, the way they play those four eyes, meaning 49 Bugs and some of those guys, they're going to try to funnel everything inside.
Yep.
And you should always attack them off tackle. Over the years, most teams have had success off tackle, making those backers run and get out of there.
Yeah, and Mack Wilson.
What about the way 15 plays this, the safety McKinney, too?
He just takes a bad angle.
But bad angle. It comes in too sharp. Comes inside too sharp.
But if you go back a little bit, and Wilson's a good physical linebacker, but by offsetting the back weak, now they don't block him.
Yeah.
30. He's the middle backer. He's stacked up on the hash. Yep.
That's Wilson.
So he's got to scrape. If Bugs is going to come down, he's got to scrape immediately.
He's late scraping, and he just doesn't have the speed to
track
him
get there.
Exactly.
That's the matchup, though.
Fast start here.
Really fast
Who's
start.
Who's got the
it's amazing, though, with these
really fast start. These young I don't know. I don't go down that path there,
okay.
Make sure.
Okay.
You know, it's amazing with these young quarterbacks how – when you know, a lot of times in the league, the quarterbacks don't even wait to hold it to throw it deep.
Right.
Like these guys they don't miss it. Like, we're like, well, we see it. We see Tua hit it.
Yeah.
Now Lawrence comes back. Yeah. Like they're waiting for the deep ball.
Yeah.
You know, they're not thinking. A lot of teams say check down and then go deep. Take the check down. These guys are going deep to short in their passing attack.
That was that big play downfield was critical for Lawrence right there.
Because
if it was available to him and he didn't hit on it,
I was worried when it first came out that he overthrew it.
Yeah, right. That was critical to him.
You got a pick six, 62-yard touchdown, and then the other long, 62.
Yeah.
So three big plays in this game.
Those are passes that last year Kelly Bryant couldn't hit.
We were talking about coverage.
They wouldn't
we got to talk about the throw, too.
Right. Yeah, I mean, it was an unbelievable throw. Yeah. And I think right now we're seeing Dabo feel really confident about his passing game.
Yep.
That's where Alabama is susceptible at on the back end. If you can block him up front. And so now the chess match, the cat and mouse game, is the Nick Saban start to bring a little bit more pressure and not allow Trevor to sit back there and get comfortable.
The speed of this.
Does this surprise you?
We
right
got a
now?
Ball game,
that
folks.
We're sitting here 14-7 and kind of this wide open and.
No,
you know,
I mean, this is what Alabama's been all year long. It's the anti Alabama.
Okay. 5 minutes in, three touchdowns.
They've had some struggles on defense, which we've seen already, and offensively, they've carried this football team.
Yeah, they don't even block Mack Wilson.
What else you got, McShay?
It's been a lot of moving parts over here.
No, it's not really. Can you flip that thing in real time? You give me any angle I want. Can we watch from Sky? We can watch a play from Sky.
No, I think it has to be.
Here he goes.
Goes back to live.
Gotcha. Inside bunch.
We're learning on the fly.
Double team.
Double teams everywhere.
Gruden-esque. Very Gruden-esque. But look, I mean, if he can pound it and get 7-8 a carry, I mean, he's going to do it. Eat the clock. Keep Lawrence on the sideline. Those guys are physical, too, man.
I forgot about the high end zone, too.
Oh, high end zone.
Nice. Look at that. Ooh. 73 come off. Just finishing.
By the way, how about Ruggs getting involved? Looking for work.
Yeah, he's looking. He didn't find much.
Yeah, but at least he's in there. Nice little 6-foot, 180-pound receiver trying to be somebody.
Oh, good tackle.
That was.
Good tackle.
That's a great tackle. You know, when you face a quarterback that is this accurate, mm-hmm. and so you can hit these guys right in stride, they don't have to turn. A lot of college quarterbacks, they can't hit it like that.
Right.
And allow the runner to run after catch. Open field tackling, mm-hmm. it's a lost art.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, where'd it go? In college football, it's like it's gone.
True.
I mean, Chip That's Kelly was what, the first one to realize, like, if I just go to my guys out in space, 9 out of 10, they can't tackle. That's a big time tackle.
Remember we sat with Tom Brady earlier this year, and Brady told us that tackling is something that, like, he's been amazed how bad the tackling
is. He was revolted.
Yeah.
You would have been fascinated by this conversation we had.
Brady? Slant up top. Put the slant up top.
There you go. That's a good ball.
But see how pre-snap they're trying to show that the double team, and then at the last second he's coming over? Tua sees that. Most young quarters don't do it. Like, pre-snap with the safety over top of it, they usually get off that read. Now watch him come back to the sky.
He's coming. He knows it.
And watch the safety at the top now run back to the middle of the field. He knows he's got one-on-one. Right there, boom, got the end cut.
But if you're the corner, you have to force him outside, though. The route that Tua throws best is slants and the deep route. Force him to outside release him now.
Now they come back with the running game, right? No.
Slant another side.
He throws the slant route and the deep route the best. I try to take the slant route away.
But look at, I mean, again, free access. Look at the amount of space that you're giving him right here.
This is, though, the college football. I mean, if you put 6 in the box, that means on the perimeter you got 1 for 1, right? And then the one safety in the middle of the field. So there's a lot of space.
You see 9 yards, you're going to take the hitch or the slant every single time. Yeah.
But it's to your point of the RPO. You know, that play fake just holds those linebackers.
Yeah, just a split.
So there's a void.
Can we go back to that, Mitch?
Yep.
Because when you play single high coverage like that, really you're playing outside leverage, right? In single high coverage, you're saying, okay, I'm not going to get beat on the outside perimeter. So shade outside. So the help has to come from inside. Circle that middle backer right there.
Yep.
Can you circle? That guy. So he's got to come back and help that slant.
Yeah,
at least make it a tough throw. But the play fake, by putting it in his stomach, he has to honor that run in this offensive line of Alabama. So watch it. See
right
it
there.
Feel? Now you can't get back off of it.
But here's the adjustment, though. Like, if you know, the thing I'm saying is, if you know they want to run slants, and that's their best route, why not walk him up? Be physical. Be physical, impress him, and make that throw less of an easy access throw.
I just don't know that you want to play this game press man-to-man.
Not every time, but you're not giving a different look.
But here's the thing.
The second he sees this backer take just a slight step,
he
knows. I mean, you're already see all the space there. But then he knows. And he's not even thinking about handing this ball off.
But you know what was the backer supposed to do? Not fill?
You know what, though?
He sees the ball going, you know.
You know, though, back to that RPO one more time. Watch the center, 71. He's running. So linebackers always say, hey, they're downfield. They're 2 yards downfield.
Yeah.
You know, he's blocking the run down.
This is the last play.
Play action. Who missed it? Wilkins came in.
He's worn him out.
Furl came in, too.
Todd's like my wife when we watch the DVR.
Yeah, she got the
motion, but she gets so far behind, and it's like, I'm getting texts in real time.
You got to use the 8-second button, not the rewind.
I'm circling
rewind button
here.
Is too extreme.
I'm trying to watch.
Oh, guys, let's go back to that play.
Take us through, Book.
Oh, let's get back. Let's get back to the last play. Let's go high end zone, McShay. All right.
Yes, sir.
73 and 99 over here. Just take a look at this. Watch 99, Cleveland Farrell. First of all, Jonah gets off balance, which you rarely ever see Jonah Williams do. But just watch him. He missed. Jonah tried to knock his hands down. Farrell is such a great athlete that he doesn't go down. and he goes to the rip and just
he blew up that
play. That's an NFL type.
You don't see Williams getting knocked
back
like that.
He's got a really good bounce.
Which means that McShay is going to be showing that piece of video 400 times this spring.
Hey, because it's one of the two NFL prospects.
You know what, though? Go to our game on Saturday. Darius Leonard. What did they tell us, Eberflus and those guys? What game did they watch with him in college?
Against Clemson. Against Deshaun.
I'm telling you, every GM in America, when they go watch tape on these guys,
this is the game they're watching.
The first thing I do is put in this game or Georgia.
Absolutely.
Or if you're playing Alabama, I mean, it's the very first thing you watch.
Look at that, man. Oh, Dabo's hot a little bit. Oh, man. Josh Jacobs with a nice block there.
Now here comes Harris. Here comes Najee Harris here. This is their big thud.
It's nice to have that's your third back.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
He's
number one recruit in the country.
Yeah. He gets about 5-6 carries a game.
Yeah, bring him in the fourth quarter, let him pound away, close out a game. Damian Harris all the way, just, chilling out.
Yeah.
Former number one running back recruit in the country. First and goal.
Jet sweep. Right, came back with it.
Found something. Ooh. Look at this.
Well.
Wasn't blocked for the... Really? Give me that replay there.
Good job faking the jet sweep.
Just full zone. They're going to zone it. A zone in 84, 82, a zone. And Harris just kind of picks and chooses.
That was really good patience.
They may mark him short here.
It's a little dip and slip. Fake in and then get back out. Outside,
right.
And holds it. Good job by him.
Yeah, he's down. He's short.
He's going to be
short. He's not even.
He's going to be on the one.
The other thing on that run, if you go back, Todd, guess what? They fake the jet sweep to Farrell's side. Right, to hold him. We don't want to run it to Farrell. We just saw what his long arms can do. So to hold it to his side come back with the run to the strong side.
Hey, did you take the cashews?
Yeah, they're over here.
Yeah, pass them back.
You already destroyed a bag.
I know,
Boog wants those cashews.
Dude,
have you ever seen anybody in your life who eats more cashews?
The thing about your cashews is I don't know how you talk because they'll think it all in your teeth.
Well, I have the wisps.
That's why you got to have water. You got to have water after the knock.
You got to get a little pick work in there. They're good for you, though. Aren't they good?
Yeah.
They're good fat.
So you eat two bags of them.
Where'd you get that water test?
Do you want the good stuff?
Yeah, the good stuff.
I got to hide the good stuff, though.
Here you.
I think there may be sales.
Todd, I'm telling you that Jacobs is going to be the number one back taken in this year's draft.
Really?
I'll bet you.
It's like we walked out of a package store and he's Boston right there.
Yeah.
You and I used to. That was like what they do in Revere. Yeah. Like off of Route 1 right there.
How'd you know?
You go get one. Wait, come on. Yeah, please. You'll get a roast beef sandwich, and then your buddy passes you a bottle like that.
Right off of Route 1.
Right off of Route 1. Is the roast beef still good up there?
Oh, yeah. North Shore.
No, he's down.
He's short.
He's short.
Yeah. Yeah, he's short. I think it's going to be, second and goal at the 1? I mean, right now. He's down. That's short.
Yeah.
I love the effort on that, though. Najee Harris, man. This kid is athletic.
Who would have thought?
He's a local kid from out here, by the way.
In the first,
seriously,
9 minutes.
Yeah, not even. You know.
They're gonna mark this thing short here.
Venables is not happy. Look at him.
No,
he's fired up.
This is not a good game to be a DC.
At the half yard line, the ball will be placed on the half yard line. It'll be second down and goal.
It's not a good sport to be a DC.
And watch Venables throughout the night. One thing I've seen with him, he's a great coordinator. He really is. But one thing you'll notice with him, he starts to get frustrated. If he's not getting home, his pass rushers.
Yeah, he does.
Think he gets frustrated. He's going to start to over-blitz a little bit. And they'll try to exploit that.
You know, the thing about Nick, though, and we all talk about how great he is, I mean, the fact that he's bought into this style of offense. I mean, Lux has done an unbelievable job this year.
We can watch Sky. There you go.
How he's evolved as a coach I can't beat it, I'm going to join him.
Yeah.
Stand up. Oh, he kept it. Look at that. Oh, action.
That was easy, wasn't it? Pinterest.
To my point of Loxley, you know, call that on first down. Great call. See how they run to the line of scrimmage, too? Don't give them time. That's a jumbo set. Look at that jumbo set.
I love that, just getting up and snapping it.
He's literally throwing it. So you can see.
He's throwing
it. Where's Hentges throwing
it to his tight end?
He releases left on the left side. Yeah,
he's not left side. He's playing left tackle.
Yeah, he's playing left tackle. You're right.
That's why he sprinted
the left. They overload jumbo to the right.
Yeah,
he's right there.
I love that. They don't even have time to see it.
No,
but look at that set. That's not only jumbo tight end.
And it looked
double jumbo tight end.
Yeah. Looks like he's just going to get a little chip on the end and go up to the second level. Yeah. And then he peels off.
But if you go back to it,
how about
Todd,
the personnel he had in there?
Look at this. So Will's the right tackle, goes to tight end. Go to Sky.
Freeze it when they get to the line so we can see everybody. So 70, 74, and 77 go to the right side.
Right, but 74 is a tight end.
Yeah.
77, 6'7", 325.
14 personnel.
So this is the guard right here, 73.
14 personnel.
Yeah.
Tackle.
Yeah, exactly.
Wing, and then the fullback, and the H-back comes over there right on the right side.
I love
There's
that.
There's eight guys on that side of the ball. I love how they get out of the huddle. And
well,
they all
I, also,
line up.
I also like the lineup in the huddle.
Well, it's the sugar huddle.
Yeah, I love that.
They're close to the line of scrimmage so they can get up there.
And if you're Clemson, somebody has to notice. First thing they have to say is unbalanced.
Yeah.
All right, unbalanced or whatever. And you got to notice the jersey number of 84.
But see, watch where 84 is in the huddle.
Yeah, because all three of those guys are
But they're on that side. Watch where 84
but
is.
But Mew's on the look at the safety. He's looking over there, saying,
"All right, see his eyes right there."
He doesn't even see him.
Yep, he doesn't see him at all.
Yeah,
and he thinks he's worried about getting blocked by 84.
Yeah,
right. That's just not being aware, though. That's just a wrinkle.
That's his responsibility.
Right. That's just a wrinkle that Mike Locklear's hid, set aside, scouted, brought it back for this game.
He chips, but he's really not even trying to chip. He just can't get through there.
Trying
on the
to get
side.
Lost.
Yeah, exactly.
Good play call, though.
Mm-hmm.
28 points.
I love this, though. Now Nick's telling, hey, guys, relax. We got to cover him now.
Yeah, but notice who he's talking to.
Yeah.
Secondary.
Whoa. Sorry, we missed it. We were looking.
Yeah.
27 points, a missed extra point.
That's correct.
Nine extra points missed by Alabama this year.
Yeah. Well, you know, they're replacing, they got Bulovos, the redshirt freshman kicker, and it's been a little shaky.
Is there team in the country you don't know the kicking situation
too close to happen? It for years there
how does that happen in Alabama?
So we went in and we met with Nick the day before their game against Missouri, and we're like, so, you know, what do you want to fix, what are you trying to get better? He's like, punting. Like, good
the boss guy. Boss JK Scott, you can't zero plays.
Most teams, it's like, well, our back.
But think about this, though.
Yeah.
This is Alabama, number one recruiting class, I don't know, 12 out of the last 20 years, whatever. They can't get a kicker.
Well, here's the deal with this kid.
I mean, think about that.
So here's, obviously, all the showcase camps have been.
By the way, Joe is our kicking expert on Monday Night Football.
So this is a kid that has leg strength
every year
and leg talent, okay? And he lit it up on the back end of his recruiting. And he came into their camp, and he looked good, and they brought him in late. What he doesn't have is he doesn't have just the basic repeatability and lift. So he doesn't get under and come through consistently and get the same rotation time after time. If you want to see him crank a big kick, he'll show you leg strength.
How about just make an extra point? How about let's do that?
But that's the thing. But all you care about is repeatability. It's not difficult. Like a free throw shooter, right? Just repeatable stroke, right?
Repeatability. Got it. Learning.
What you want. Yeah.
You know,
and he was shaky in warm-ups, by the way, when we were watching him. He did not have a good warm-up.
Here we go.
Well, they're just showing how, you know, Kelly didn't, when you look at these plays, Lawrence isn't going to miss these.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. And I think that's what, you know, we all know that's why Dabo made the move for that.
Now you see these corners looking at it, we got singled up. They're going to start pressing if they don't go back in those stats.
Run left. Yep. Oh.
What's he got?
Play action. Bootleg.
Oh, man. Thompson closed on that.
But that's how I think they're going to have to win this game. They got to get him outside. They got to get him outside on the perimeter.
Thompson here. He's the best free safety in the country.
I think that's
he's a little late throwing that ball.
Yeah, McKinney on that one.
He's a little 15. Late.
Oh, is it?
Pause it.
Yeah,
watch.
That's McKinney.
Okay. Pretty good close.
Yeah. It was, but he's got Renfro. Now.
Yep.
Let it fly. Pull right on the inside of that four. Here they come, man.
Yeah, bring that back, Todd.
Yep. You're going to put it in the sky.
Yeah. Just watch the big boys inside. They're going to try to zone it. Nah.
Is that 92?
Yeah, that's 92.
Shocking.
Please.
This kid is so good.
Yeah, but watch it. Here's the thing that eats up zone blocks with penetration. All right, if you're going to zone that, 75 Mitch Hyde has got to come. You can't be late. You got to come because he'll just eat it up, man. Big guys with thin ankles, man. We eat up.
Third and 14, backed up.
Here comes Mack Wilson. He's faking his buffer.
Yeah, they only brought four.
Good protection.
Great protection, especially on the left side against Jennings.
What happened to Renfro there?
Did he slip?
He's out of bounds.
That's two times he's just been like physical for a moment.
But you know
who's he matched up with there? I can't see from that. That's so far away.
That's
Thompson.
No, it might be McKinney.
15?
That's McKinney.
That's McKinney. 15 McKinney.
It's two plays in a row for McKinney.
Wow, that may be a little PI though.
Well, the ball isn't out.
Yeah.
So you can hand check. That's a difference in NFL and college.
But go back right there. Go back and circle Trevor Lawrence's head for me, McShay. Yep. At the top of the stack.
Yep.
At the top of his drop. He gets right there. Freeze it right there. Circle his head. See where he's looking? He's not looking anywhere else
now.
But Trevor Lawrence. Renfro. That's the only place he's looking at Renfro. And that's twice on third down. He stares straight at Renfro every time. You think Alabama doesn't know he's a third down weapon?
The thing about though, can you go back to the second down play, Todd? You're going to get a lot of work in, brother.
It's going to be a couple minutes, but we'll get there.
How long is that cord there?
Watch yourself.
Second half. So on the second down play, this is the game.
This is third and 14.
Within the game.
That's pretty good, though.
I got more, bud.
I know you do.
I got more flavors for you.
Oh, I got this too. You may like that.
What do you want, Sky?
Watch Carter up top. No, this is perfect. Okay. In the slot. So now he's going to blitz. And you guys are talking about Williams, how good he does. But by bringing that edge pressure on second down, he's unblocked. So the ball has to now come back inside.
Show me that again.
Right
back
into the Williams.
Yep.
So Carter's in the slot. And he plays right there. So it looks like a six-man box. You want to run it. Right. Sometimes he drops. Sometimes he comes. But he hides it. He hides the blitz. And one of the things Nick does is he delays that blitz till after the ball snap. So a lot of teams go to the hot, to see, right? You're going to blitz. And Nick tells him, don't go until the ball snaps. And when he does, he comes off the edge. Now, he doesn't make the play.
Which is hard to do.
But the runner has to come back inside. He sees it. It's wide zone. It's coming right at him. Oh, he's unblocked. I got to come back. And there's so many goes back to the big boys.
So many times in college, with the clap of the hand or the step, and then they start to creep a little bit.
They all creep.
Quarterbacks.
NFL, they do it as well, too. But that's a nice adjustment of, is he going to come or is he not?
Comes Brennan.
That
double A gap.
Feeling
your point.
He's bringing double A gap. That means he's got
picked it up.
Oh, nice catch!
Great catch!
How about that, Wick?
It's unbelievable.
This kid, Judy, man.
He brings both backers. It's man free.
He did the old delay blitz. Yeah, look at 34. Pretend like he's going to drop.
Right.
22 just yawns at it. Yep. Watch 34 just drop it. He's going to pretend like he's going to drop in coverage.
But. Even though it's a blitz, freezing once two against right there, freeze it right there.
Yep.
It's a blitz, but it's picked up. It's six
doesn't
for
matter.
Six.
Yep.
If you're going to blitz him, you got to bring more Nick to pick
bring
up.
An extra man.
Right.
How about that catch?
Nice catch.
Judy.
Catch is great.
Of course.
Nice catch.
Man, he's good.
Ooh. Harris.
He runs.
Doesn't he?
Everything's 100 miles an hour.
Exactly.
Where does he go on your draft day?
I think he's day two.
Day two?
I don't think he's elite, but I think the thing he does that NFL backs typically do is everything is full speed, cutting full speed.
What it's blocked for, he will get.
And he will get, exactly.
Yep. Who's the first back off the board?
It could be him. Bryce Love. It could be Jacobs, too.
I'm telling you, Jacobs. That's how thin of a running back crop we have.
No Saquon Barkley in this year's draft.
No Saquon Barkley in the next 10 years' draft.
You know Judy going to make that catch? When it's low and in front of you, a lot of guys do this. Mm-hmm. He turns those hands like that. Yeah. And he gets catch the ball.
Gee, do we have a ball in here? Can we get a football in here?
That's two times in this series, Venables has brought extra guys. He's got the nickel coming, and he's got the backer coming. Here comes the nickel, here comes the backer.
Well, the one thing is the backers can really hit it.
Yeah.
Because he had ankle surgery.
Yeah.
You know,
right.
A month ago.
Right.
So he's not keeping it.
Yep. And he's got the nickel, by the way, coming off the bottom of the screen.
It's under 3 minutes to play in the first quarter, and that's the first time we mentioned that this quarterback had ankle surgery a month ago.
And a knee injury.
What does that say about the way he's playing?
Yeah. It's 10 of 12.
But notice what Alabama did at the bottom of the screen. They went a little stack, inside run. They got to fit it up, make the tackle. There you go. Now he's short. Fourth and one. What are we doing here?
Oh, you got to go for it.
It's just what counts.
Especially when your kicker just missed an extra point.
Yeah, here they come. Jacobs is coming.
They're going to go for it. And look, this is a big stop for Clemson. I mean, their offense hasn't played extremely well.
Right.
Right? I mean, so you can get a stop here. Maybe get a little momentum for Clemson.
Boy, and Nick is basically saying, I'm giving up points here. Because, I mean, I know the kicker's bad, but you would think he could make
it. An extra point. I mean, you know, I mean, I know he missed one, but you got to feel confident. I think it's a mindset.
He also saying,
oh, Wildcat.
That was too easy.
It always amazes me when you get fourth and a half an inch and you go shotgun.
Backing yourself up to go 1 inch forward.
It's amazing, but this is the Wildcat. Get the extra pull.
I wonder if they're going to go tempo here, too.
Do you think they'll get to the line? I like Leatherwood.
Yeah.
70 to play. Kid playing rugby. Came in and played tackle in the second half of last year's game.
Yeah.
There's the jumbo again. Now they're going to run it.
And it's unbalanced.
Yeah.
Didn't get it.
Very similar formation. Tackle over.
It was the same
exact one.
Yeah, 84.
74, 77.
Yep. There they go.
Yep.
Got 84 at the 84 at the left tackle spot. Jonah Williams is down at guard.
Yeah, he's a tackle.
Comes back with it.
He's a guard.
Yep.
How about the righting?
I can say hooked on phonics is working.
That's good.
I can do letters and everything.
No, you look like a 3-year-old when you circle it.
No, dude.
You've gotten better, though.
Do you understand?
I like my fingers sticking to this thing.
Early on.
I'm just saying.
I need
like
a pen.
Motion.
Double state is not easy.
Oh.
Back him up.
Especially when you do it every single play 14 times a play.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
You want to see somebody get, like, hot like a hornet?
Yeah.
When Telly's not working perfect.
Oh.
Yeah.
Bro. Hey, it's not working. I'm touching the screen. It's not working.
Crisis.
You know what happened? Our second preseason game, we had one, and I was watching the coverage, and Simon, the DN for the Colts, he's now with the Patriots.
The one they cut.
He gets a sack. So I'm Jay Rothman's like, hey, we're going sky here right away, right?
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, I didn't see it. So I'm just thinking, he had to just come around the edge.
Yeah, it was a game.
Nice sack.
It was a game.
Yeah. And he came, and so I draw it up. It's a preseason game, second game, out of the rattle. Man, you got
good stuff.
You got it, so. Jay's like, forget about it, man. It happened. Don't worry about it.
Oh.
You know what that penalty does?
Hey.
So I went home and practiced with Illustrator.
What are you doing? McShay, this is...
you taking, like, a highlighter on a mirror? What are you doing?
Go back to Super Bowl. New England Patriots play.
Throwing out TVs?
this is the old New England Patriots play where they motion Edelman in.
Yep.
On the stack, throw it right there. Now he's got two blockers.
Now he's got two blockers in front. Yep.
Yeah, that's the old Patriots play.
It? But if go back to it again.
Yep.
If you can. That same view. And I love the play. I'm with you, Boog. I think he could go on the perimeter. I think he could catch it and then get to the sideline.
You're never going
to back in.
You're never going to believe this. You're never going to believe this.
Yeah.
We're taking our first commercial break. What time is it?
I like
an hour and
commercial break. That means I can actually enjoy my break.
Hey, everybody, we welcome you back here to the MegaCast College Football Playoff National Championship. This is the Monday Night Football Film Room with the addition of our NFL draft expert, Todd McShay. Todd, you've been awesome tonight, man.
Thanks, buddy.
This is so nice to chill with you here up here.
We had enough complaints, we just moved the Telestrator.
I saw that.
Went to the bullpen.
Yeah. Wait, you're getting involved?
Yeah, I'm going to go at it. It's not
interesting.
Easy.
14 trusting Clemson.
No, I'm going to sit back and enjoy this for a minute.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yeah, we got a bunch
to make sure it works.
Yeah, we're good.
All right.
We're going to start.
And of course, the first thing he does is draw a route. That's what tight ends and receivers do.
Look at the time of possession in the first quarter. Bama, the missed extra point. Now they're trying to take the lead here. What do you expect?
Bunch there.
Throw it out there.
Quick flat up top.
Flat
up top.
Clemson.
Yeah, 11, flat, 11 to the flat.
Clemson national championship.
11 to the flat. There it is.
Oh, came with the shovel.
Oh. Great play by Brian.
Maybe they should have gone with up top.
You got the remote?
I do not. Do you have the remote?
Yeah.
I thought you, stole that too. Yeah.
I mean, somebody's got to have the remote.
There we go. Austin Bryant just plays it. Oh, just plays it. So that was a neat little concept. So you got the bunch. Levin came with the motion to show you where this man is zoned. He's running to the flat. You got Tua coming out. And so it's either shovel. They want Bryant to.
But he's coming on bunch.
Right, exactly. They want Bryant to think Bryant to either go with the shovel or take Tua. He kind of stays in the middle and played in between. Watch him. He just kind of sets in the middle right there.
Yep. That's a tough read though for Tua.
But if you're Tua, if Brian's sitting there, maybe you go and you take the flat route.
Watch Tua's eyes though. He's trying to take a peek. See, he's looking out.
Yeah, he is.
And then he goes back, like his head's going back and forth. You know, it's a tough read.
They covered the.
See him looking?
The flat route.
Decent.
But there was a little bit of miscommunication.
Because Judy was open right there.
If you go back,
Yeah. So he's trying to read that. Right.
There.
Yeah.
See, both corners, both DBs
came off
of him for the flat route, and then you have Judy right there. Yeah, would have been open.
Watch your water, but there's thank you.
But he had already made the decision.
And he's getting, you know.
Yeah, it would have been too late.
Yeah. So Tua, since the pick six, is 10 for 11, 130 yards, and 2 touchdowns right now.
Wow.
If they retake the lead. Can you do me a favor? Are you guys done with that?
Yeah.
Because I'm going to just coach you up one thing on special teams here. Go show me the field goal. I want to show you something here. Okay. I want you to give me the behind. Go back to field goal. I want to watch the trajectory of the kick. Do you remember what I said, that he doesn't have repeatability because he doesn't have lift? Watch the trajectory of the kick. Here, watch the trajectory. Can you get any high? Can you get any sky or high end zone?
Sky.
This is a punch, not a lift. Watch the trajectory. Watch how there's no lift. Okay. You see this? Keep it going. You see? Okay. You see that ball should be.
Yeah.
Right. Should be. Okay. Because now he's missed an extra point. He's just looking to punch it through. I would not trust him if this game comes down to a field goal of distance. Even though he's got leg talent, there's concern there right now. Because he's just trying to punch it through.
Here's the other thing about this game. All right, Alabama, 26 offensive plays, Clemson 10.
Yeah.
Yeah,
you know?
And 220 total yards to 86.
You think that one big play offensively for Clemson, they got to respond now. Five-man box, you know, see him coming up to the top?
Yeah.
How they get that six guy. So you got to throw it now.
Yeah,
so seeing that coming, you got to throw
it. Dylan Moses, he's coming.
Yep.
Surprised he didn't go there. We go left side. He's going to be straight man to man.
That's going to be pass interference on Savion Smith.
Yeah, it's a pass interference. But the thing is, so he gets the six guys, right? You got five and then him. But watch here. He comes up and then he plays out underneath it. Nick's got him taught pretty well on how to play it.
Do that again for me, Whit.
See, 30. He's coming to take away that slant in there. Now, he does hold him. He gets the PI on it. So I guess my point is, show a six-man box. They only have five. It's going to force him to throw it and then get the linebackers to play back out. Get some underneath help.
Hit live.
Yep.
There you go.
Nice cut.
Screen.
Good call with the screen game.
Yeah, just a screen game. You can't block him. Don't try to.
Look, though, he's unblocked right here, coming up. He beats his lineman out in space. Makes a miss, though.
And then you got 74, John Simpson, coming back to kind of steal a play.
Yeah.
They are so deep a receiver. They just roll in and out.
You don't want Lawrence taking those hits.
No, not at all. He's got Wilson coming up, helmet to helmet there.
That is.
Yeah, maybe it's hard.
Surprised they don't.
Go ahead, say it, McShay.
Surprised they're not going to look at it harder.
Yeah, that's what I was just thinking.
Absolutely.
Good run.
I feel like every time you look up, teams are back in scoring position.
No question.
Yep.
Like, we just started the second quarter with Alabama down into, in the red zone.
Right.
get them out. Minutes. When you spread them out so much, one guy misses a tackle, like on that screen play, you're 20 yards into it.
Bottom of the screen, you got single, you got one-on-one, Savion Smith. I may take a look at the bottom of the screen.
Who's he with? T. Higgins?
I think he's going to run it.
Yeah.
He's not he's looking drag. For the top.
Got it. Touchdown. Touchdown.
Get upfield. That was Higgins coming from the whole other side of the field.
Yeah, yeah.
He kind of threw that. He kind of. Yeah, but go ahead.
Yeah, if you take a look
circle
at it,
circle five there.
It's trips to the top of the screen, right. And everybody with the trips
and they
just
all
run
come this
inside
way.
Route.
Yep.
Right, and you get Higgins hole, screaming across the field, and it's hard for those guys to communicate that. So that,
problem
that's,
is he's trying to pass it off, and these guys are running, right?
Yeah.
And if Lawrence hits that in stride, he kind of hits that. He has to turn back. That's always a tough one.
First and goal. Is he in? He's going to be at the line.
I love when the linemen come in behind and push.
In the
that's like cheating. Quentin that's like cheating.
That's cheating. That's effort play.
That's cheating. It's not effort. That's cheating.
Can we see it from Scott?
I wish I had somebody to push me to the quarterback every play. I mean, come on.
There you go.
Watch him. Oh, that's good.
He's short. Quarterback's
here. Here we go. Second and goal.
What do you call here?
From the one. I throw that fade up top.
I hate the fade. It's the worst play.
And then you
football.
Can be sitting here at third goal. Or just do that.
Yeah. Stop messing around.
Yeah.
They needed a drive like that, though. Running the
football. I agree.
We talked about when you get in these type of games, don't forget about the run.
They were far more balanced on that.
Right
instead of just hitting the big play. And,
yeah.
By zoning it off.
He's reading it.
Yeah. But zoning this off, but they're climbing right here up top. And he's reading this. You're right.
Right. Todd. That's what
exactly
he's reading.
Right.
So his eyes. But Todd, go back to the
Sears eyes are.
Yeah. Yep. But go back to the top of the play, Todd.
Yep.
And circle the nose guard 92.
Yeah, he plays around.
He's running a stunt. So what they're trying to do is run a stunt, and they actually vacate away from where the ball is going.
Oh, yeah. That's why zoning it off for the offensive line.
Exactly.
Is the right play.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
So if you zone it off, they can move and do what they want to. It doesn't matter.
Yeah. Thank you. You're actually helping us.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Right. Right. Right.
Can you take me back there, please?
Yes, sir.
To the kick?
No.
I don't mean you're the kicking expert.
I'm so sick of talking about kicking, please.
You're sick of talking about it. I feel like I'm sitting next to Jan Stenerud back
there. Jan Stenerud is a great ski jumper. What's up, G?
Yeah, so if we're looking at that play right there, you know, sometimes as a defense, we stunt and we're guessing because we're trying to figure out where the ball is going. Alabama must know something. They're stunning toward the back. So 92 is coming to the back, and he vacates the hole, but you got Mac Wilson filling. So notice what they do. 92 goes out, watch Mac Wilson. As soon as the ball snaps,
he's coming here, he's going over there.
And Mac Wilson is coming downhill, number 30 right there. He's coming down.
They just full zone it, though.
Yeah, and if you're Clemson, that's what you do.
Yeah.
He's coming down, center picks it up, it's a walk-in.
Both teams are 2 for 2 in the red zone. You cannot afford to miss. I mean, you know, Alabama had a nice drive, 10-play drive, kick a field goal.
Mm-hmm. Right.
That's what. It's not. You would think in most cases, hey, we've scored 16. We're 19 minutes into the game. We're fine.
Final possession is 12 minutes to 5 minutes. Clemson leads 21-16.
Yeah.
Well, I think what's
pick
looming
six,
large
obviously.
Is
pick two, six. That's seven of it.
Pick
right
six,
there.
Yeah. Mixed extra, missed extra point. Those are the two things that are looming large right now.
That's 17-14, Bama.
Right.
Bama's just so methodical. That's what I'm saying. If you get down there, you think, oh, okay, nice drive. We settle for a field goal. No, you have got to capitalize every time you get in the red zone in this game tonight.
I think we saw that with Nick's last decision.
Yeah.
You know, we can say it's because the kicker's not kicking well, but I think he realizes what kind of game we're in.
Absolutely.
We're in a different game.
Yep. How many guys are legit potential first round, top 35, 45?
I've got 8 on these first two teams, on these teams, in the first 35 overall players. Now, one of them, Dexter Lawrence, is not playing.
Yeah.
But, so that means 7 are on the field tonight, which is really unique. Is Williams going to be the highest one taken on the field? Yeah, I mean, he legitimately could be the first overall pick. Him and Nick Bosa, I think, are the top two out of Ohio State. So if you're Arizona and you have Rosen, who's your quarterback?
The first five teams drafting.
Don't need quarterbacks.
Don't need quarterbacks.
Yeah, don't need quarterbacks.
So the first team is the Giants sitting at six.
Right.
Jacksonville at seven. It's going to be interesting because Haskins is a really good player. And I think he's got a chance to be a good starter in the league. But are you going to trade up? It could be a cat and mouse game.
Is Williams, is he a 3-4 or 4-3 guy?
Who, Quinnen?
Quinnen Williams, yeah.
I think he's 4-3.
4-3. So now if you're Arizona, who they hire as coach and defense coordinator may determine whether they take Williams number one overall. Because if he's a 4-3-3 technique, and you can build around him, now you take him number one overall, like they did with Dan Wilkerson, Cincinnati did with Dan Wilkerson.
Yep.
And, you know, in that situation.
So really,
I mean, he's 6'4", 300.
Was in there.
3'4", 4'3". You don't see a guy going that high.
Arizona.
4'I". I'm
scheduled to Arizona and maybe the Jets.
You see LaFleur got the Green Bay job, or is going to get the Green Bay job?
So.
Yeah.
The hot shot 30-something offensive guys, McShay.
Everyone wants.
You were that at one point, McShay.
At one point.
And you said, I want to be a TV
show. I want to work with
you
Joe Tess.
You could have been an NFL head coach.
He said, I want to be the next Mel Kiper.
Yeah, exactly.
Ty, there we go.
We're heavy defense this spring.
Oh, yeah.
Heavy defensive.
Heavy D-line.
Oh, yeah.
Run it. We're going to jump off and make tackles.
Got to.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, it sounds so simple
to our conversation, right? It's not what the game is. You have a generation of kids that are playing 7-on-7 ball, spread ball, shotgun ball, open space ball, outside the numbers.
Five-man box, he has to be the guy come down and make that tackle.
Yep.
Empty set.
There's you go.
You think it's a bubble screen up top?
I think it's going back into the back there.
Same play.
Yep. Trying to spread them out and run.
Yeah. Trips to the field.
Yep.
Get your strength to the field, run it back weak.
Well, because essentially that's 4/3 up top.
Correct.
Who's got the pen?
There is no pen.
What do you mean? Oh, you get your finger there?
Sticky finger.
What Venables does a good job is his sixth guy that comes down when they go empty like that. Mm-hmm. Really the safety is who he has to come down. Most guys, it's the nickel slot. That's how it is. But for him,
a lot of times it's Muse, that 230-pound safety.
Yeah.
Interesting decision right here. 4th-and-1 on the minus the minus 35? And Saban is keeping the offense on the field. It's 4th-and-inches on the minus 35.
Yeah. Yeah, just short of the minus 35.
Are you serious?
Let's go to Stafford.
Apparently he is. Yeah. This is big right here.
It should say live.
He goes to Wildcat again.
Yeah, of course. He was in there.
Yeah.
You know what, though? In big games, I always feel like the head coach has to have his fingerprints on the game.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, like the actual X's and O's of the game.
He's got to make that
twice
tackle.
Now. Yeah. Nick has made these calls.
Yeah, right here. You get the one-on-one you want.
Yeah, you got to make that tackle.
I love that Nick's.
Well, the onside kick the first time they played for a national championship, right?
Making those decisions to go for it.
Now he's going to throw. Oh, sticking with it.
I like Jacobs.
Yeah.
You're high on him, Todd?
Yeah, I mean, he's come on. He's been the guy recently. He had the most carries last week.
He's the guy I said he's going to be number one back. I'll bet you guys a nice lemonade.
All right.
First back taken.
Could be.
Is that a Napa lemonade?
Tell you what. That. Next time I come to Dallas, dinner at Nick and Sam.
Oh. I got it. Now you get your 8-man protection. Now you take a shot down the field.
I was just thinking play action.
Nope.
Just going to stay with it.
No, this is
a man miss.
Nice move.
Look at that. Nice. I think the field gave way a little bit there, huh?
It has a few times.
They had like 2 inches of rain yesterday.
Yeah, but they've had a tarp on it, but.
Yeah.
But this is.
It didn't seem bad when we were walking on there pregame.
Look at that cut, though.
But this is what you get when you get a new field. Look, that whole chunk came up.
Reminds me of Adrian.
See that divot? That's like with one eye there.
I can see that.
Top goal.
You know Adrian Foster, the cuts?
Yeah.
Jacob's getting some work here, man. He's up to 8 attempts.
Well, you know the one thing we haven't seen?
Bringing pressure. Picked it up.
Pick it, oh, pick it,
man.
He's going strong.
Oh, man.
Four interceptions all year.
Trayvon Mullen.
He's got two tonight.
Look at this. Somebody can get over there?
He threw. Jeez.
Four interceptions on the year.
Two against Georgia, I believe.
Yeah. Well, that was his.
But here's the thing. He gets greedy. Like, some. He's a really accurate throw, but right.
Three guys converted.
Yeah.
He got to take the underneath.
Watch here. The tight end right there.
Yeah, exactly.
Watch 84.
He's
84
gonna,
right
he's
there.
He's going to break off from there, and this is the throw instead of trying to go
either,
down.
Either him.
The backer carries, you throw it underneath.
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
As soon as the backer carries, you throw it underneath.
Show us that, Witt. Circle the backer.
Well, what happens is they're playing this shell coverage. He's playing back, and then he carries back, so this linebacker's got to come off. When he comes here, this linebacker drops, he's got to come off. Instead, he carried it, and then nobody played underneath.
So as soon as he stays with the receiver, you go to the tight end.
Right now.
Right there.
Now, yeah, right there. I'm throwing it right inside.
There. Either that tight end or the tight end in the middle of the field.
The only thing on this tight end is that tight end safety. He's coming here. Yeah. To
and he hasn't turned. He hasn't turned yet.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Yeah, he wasn't gonna.
What happens though? Sometimes with young quarterbacks, even though they want to make and you have so much success like he did,
right?
You know, and you made magic happen. You want to press the ball down the field.
Yep.
And if you're running the ball like that, just keep taking it.
Yeah.
Throw it underneath 5 yards. Run after the catch. We see these guys can't tackle very well in open space. Don't get greedy, I guess, is what I'm saying.
That's it. Well, I agree with you on that.
Now, what do they do with this?
You better be careful. That Surtain came off of that.
Yeah.
You notice that?
Yeah.
You better be careful with that. Watch.
Yeah.
Right? Watch the corner at the top of the screen.
Right here. He's going to come off.
Watch him come off of that. You better be careful. Out, watch him come off right there. You better be careful there.
That was pretty quick for a freshman corner.
Yeah. You know, his dad's got a lot of houses built coming off routes like that.
Yeah.
Went right back to it.
Yeah. He had the linebacker with him.
Watch Renfro, though. When he runs this route, a lot of times, guys, is that me? A lot of guys, they come up and they run right here, and now he can come off. He stems inside to buy himself space on the outside.
Really good. Watch him run it. Watch him push inside.
Yeah.
He knows that corner's out. Now he buys that space.
He bounces it.
Yeah, but by sticking in, it looks like he's going to run a crossing route.
You need 5-6 yards.
There comes the star.
Some pressure off the edge. They blow the whistle?
Yeah, I don't think it was a play. I think it was no play.
No, they ran it. They were just blowing the whistle because the helmet came off. He's got to come off the field.
Renfro, good route, though, sticking in and then coming out. And then up top, him outside releasing on that play. When he outside releases, it pulls the corner wider.
Yeah, pulls
the
corner wider,
Dabo and the staff do a good job.
Short screen.
He pulled it off. That's so dangerous.
Jeez.
You pump a screen? And you stick
it. But I don't know.
It wasn't a screen. What happened was he thought he was blitzing.
Yeah.
And really, he peeled off. He acts like he's blitzing, then he pulls off. Watch him.
But check out 75.
75's going out.
Yeah. Yeah. 75, yeah. Mitch Hyatt, free releases. That's almost like the New Orleans Saints.
Yeah, the old school scheme. Yeah. Like the screen getting
right,
in space.
Right, exactly.
But at this point, you got, I mean, he saw him start to drop, and he still went to it. You got to throw it away. No question.
Absolutely.
Saints run that play a lot. It's just a one line of screen.
Third and 7. They coming?
Yeah.
Picked it up.
Back in 2-man.
Boy, he drove that ball, didn't he, right there?
I mean, it's
that's Rodgers.
Look at
that's
throw,
T.
Though.
That's T's son, isn't it? Amari Rodgers?
Yeah, it is.
Yes.
That's T. Martinson.
Good route.
It gets confusing because they also have a T.
They have a T. Higgins.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I love how he steps up in the pocket. Lawrence just, I mean, he looks like a Peyton Manning or that type, you know, when they're young, just stepping up and with his fundamentals.
That was his guy growing up. Peyton's is
kind of has that build to him.
Yeah, he does.
You know?
Tall, sturdy, pocket present kind of guy. This doesn't quite... Now, listen, the Clemson offense is good, and obviously the kid's talented. This doesn't quite feel like an Alabama defense.
No, it's not.
Well, normally with Alabama defenses, they have one dominant corner. Mm-hmm. And Nick can play, take that dominant corner, lock him up man-to-man, and he can work around with the other guys. They don't have that. They got a JUCO transfer in Savion Smith and a freshman in Surtain. Savion Smith just got beat by Rodgers in the deep end cut. He doesn't have the corners that he normally has.
Nice. Shovel.
Touchdown.
Good block, too. Interior guys are great here.
Watch how he pushes up field, though, and then tries to close.
That's what opens it up.
Hit that again, Whit.
Yeah, so he sees him right here, and he's reading this guy, right? And he's gonna, instead of coming down the line, he comes up. So it creates all this space for him to have on the perimeter. And they pull the guard on the backside. So there goes his guard pulling. But they're still, he plays up, that creates that lane.
This is the same play. Tua ran.
Yep.
Same play. Bring it back.
Yep.
It's motion.
Yep.
It's little shuttle motion that trips. Defensive end played because he tried to play it the same way. He's trying to buy time. All right.
Same exact play.
I think it's 28-16.
The difference was his end played down inside.
Exactly.
That one he played outside.
Correct.
Up. We're rolling, brother.
We're back.
Yeah. Thank you. Hey. Thank you for bringing us back.
We lost Joe Tess. I couldn't hear him in my ear.
That's the best.
You're doing this to me. I'm like, what? All right, we're back. We're back. Welcome back to the national championship. What do you guys think of Tua? Todd, what do you think of Tua here in the first half?
He's made two big mistakes. And I think, you know, Nick's not going to go away from him or do anything like that. But you saw on that drive where he just threw a second interception, it was clear that Saban said, you know what, we've got to run the football and let's commit to the ground game. And they ran the ball four or five times before throwing. I think we're going to see a little bit more of that. I think for whatever reason, maybe it's the looks he's getting, he's made a couple big mistakes.
He's greedy.
Yes.
That's been the knock on this kid all year long. Like, he loves the big play, loves the home run. But we can talk about two all we want to. What about my guy? Sunshine, baby.
Oh, man.
He's 9-15 for 154 and a tug. Come on. It might be dark in Santa Clara, but sunshine is shining tonight, baby. Come on.
I tell you, when he throws for 400, you're going to call him Lawrence, all right?
Maybe. At that point, maybe.
Thing about it, though, for Alabama, they have almost 100 yards rushing. So, I mean, get back to it.
They're down 12, though. See,
I know, but you got plenty of time. That's the thing about it. You got plenty of time.
Here's my prediction right now. 4:38 left in the quarter. Nick Saban's defense is tired. Yep. Nick is going to say, I don't want to put this defense back on the field the rest of this half. But how do we do that? We're going to play action pass, but we're going to run the football. I look for a heavy dose of run with a little play action here and there.
That's what they did at the end of the half against Oklahoma.
Exactly.
Yeah, they got the ball with about 6 minutes left.
And just, range. Exactly. And just, there you go.
Yep.
Were you down there? Were you down in Miami for that?
Yep. Radio call.
Nice. Right.
Steve Levy and
I should have been driving around in my car all night just listening to you.
I'm just curious. Normally at halftime when I'm at home watching the game, somebody brings food. My wife will
whatever
bring
you
some
want.
Food.
Just
is anybody bringing us? Like, cause I'm tired of
what do you want?
Like, I'm tired of these cashews right now. I need a piece of meat or something, dude.
Can we get some book some protein?
Yeah, like
before he faints.
Yeah, some barbecue or something. I mean, come on.
A bunch of sweets around.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Thing you don't realize in it, calling so many pro games, just with the clock stopping as frequently as it does in college. You forget about that. I mean, 4:38 is a lot of time. Mm-hmm. You know?
Watching NFL games, it's a huge difference. Like, even just watching the playoff games this weekend, it's always like that.
Yeah, yeah. Well, I mean, just from a play calling standpoint, you know.
Can I grab a coffee?
Well, and what you're talking about is in college, every time you make a first down, clock stops, they reset the chain.
Oh,
So you don't necessarily have to call a timeout, which that's different than the pro game.
Lawrence is at 154 and a touchdown.
Mark. Yep.
Etienne, two touchdowns.
You left the room for a minute and they came back.
Yes.
And I didn't handle it very well.
What happened?
Couldn't hear. Just said, hey, we're back.
Yeah.
just the greatest,
we're back.
The greatest welcome back America we're call
back.
You've heard.
We're back. We're back. We welcome you back to the Monday Night Football film room here at the College Football Playoff National Championship from here in Santa Clara.
I said we're back.
I'm Todd McShay. This is the future Hall of Famer, Jason Witten, the two-time Super Bowl champion.
No, he didn't hear.
And just a poor little kid from Schenectady, New York, trying to pay some bills.
Trying to pay some bills. Who are you talking about?
At some point when you bring him back, just call him the son of an Italian immigrant. That's what he loves to go by.
Anna Miranda.
Anna Miranda.
Oh, yeah, man. I mean, like level 12 espresso if you have it. Thank you.
I'll take
one. It's
one
more than 11. It's a Spinal Tap espresso.
Witten. Thank you, bud.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's the difference in the game. Two turnovers. 14 points off of turnovers. Mm-hmm.
Always is, right? It's a funny vibe out here for a championship game, isn't it?
It's not a football town. It doesn't feel like it.
No.
You know?
Got themselves a football game, though, here.
Good weather, though, today.
Today was. Yesterday was a washout.
Pound it. Run left.
Let's see.
You know it.
Yeah. Oh, him with the RPO.
Good tackle.
Take us through it.
You just go ahead, Todd.
Switches over the back. I mean, it's basic free access right there. He sees the cornerback off and just flings it out.
Oh, thank you so much.
It's a nice pluck, too.
Oh, somebody got to come get that. Let's take a look at this drive and see how many times they run the football on this drive.
Watch what they do to Farrell. Farrell's going to come down the line and in a good vision.
It's a stunt, though.
Yeah, like,
Farrell, the three technique and the five technique are stunting inside.
Oh, Boog, that's your favorite stunt.
Yeah, it's a pirate stunt.
That's a pirate stunt.
Yeah, both coming inside.
Yeah, but where's the outside man?
He's got a scrape.
He doesn't. Yeah, because he's late inside.
Yeah, 57 is late.
But because they're setting it up for him, and 57 doesn't come.
The other thing is, I think he sees this pull guard.
Yeah,
coming.
So he follows the pull.
So he's thinking
that's
there.
His first read.
Is offset back, offset weak. You're thinking run there.
Exactly.
But he visioned to then come back out.
But it's designed for him to come right where it went.
So if he's slanting, then he's got to be over there.
Exactly. But he's got to know the slant is not going to let that ball go that way.
And as a linebacker, you've got two things to read. The first is your key of the guard.
That's right.
And then the second thing you got to do, though, is find the football. And what he does, he makes his first one, but he doesn't make the second one, and he's late.
Bama's averaging over 5 yards per run.
See? And that's Najee Harris, the third back.
Oh, that's good. Thank you, Lance.
You got a little espresso there?
It's not espresso, but it's strong enough.
But Nick's slowing it down. Tempo.
Right. In between
40. Yeah.
Well, so if you told him right now, let's bring this clock down and have 28-23 and go into the half and reset, you're saying, okay, I'm comfortable with that. Don't give them the ball right before the half.
They're probably going to snap around 10 because they want to keep enough time on the clock.
Hey, Witt.
Third and six.
Coin toss.
And on top of that, they get the ball back to start
coin toss.
Yeah. Why are they playing?
They defer. They get the ball. Oh, he's coming in. Oh, man. They recovered it. Boy, he took a shot there, huh?
Whoa.
That was Mullen on a corner blitz.
Off the motion.
Off the motion.
Wow.
See that
they drew him right into it. Look at this.
Wow. Off the motion.
Cat blitz.
Here he comes.
We'll see where cat from a cut split. You very rarely see that.
And look on how the far short off side. The safety is, too. Usually you'll see the safety cheating up even closer if they're going to go with it.
Get that ball. Now they got a.
Oh, they had a big play.
Oh, that's it.
They did. He's screaming for it. He doesn't have any clue it's coming, just like we're all surprised that he wound up coming off the motion, too.
But look, he's got to cover the back who's coming around here, and he gets caught in this. But you see,
Tua's looking
at
the other side.
But also,
he's looking at the other side.
But also, look at, I want you to watch the receiver. He's got two reads here. Watch this on the drag route.
Yeah,
oh, the drag's available.
Because this safety messes it up, twice.
Who's he locked in on? The number two receiver to the top?
That's the whole thing.
He's locked on the number two receiver to the
top,
right?
He should either have, with the corner coming, the safety usually is the guy who's going to come up and take the wide receiver, okay? And then if he's not taking the receiver, then he's got to come out and take the back out of the backfield. He does neither. He goes inside and doubles this tight end. And then you'll see what happened. Two wide open receivers, but two is looking to the other side of the field. He has no idea that this is coming. At this point, right here, open receiver, open back. What a huge play. That was a risky play by Clemson.
Sure was.
Yeah, you know the other thing about that corner cat is the fact that he comes inside. They run him out, and then he comes inside.
Yeah.
Usually corner cats are off the edge. I mean, the fact that he comes inside, I mean.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, he goes inside of the tackle.
In the C-gap.
Yeah.
Yep.
You almost think this was a check.
I don't know, because look at the D lineman. He's running this pick too.
Yep, Christian Wilkins.
Yeah,
and then they get the B gap blitz. If Bama doesn't motion the receiver in, what happens there?
But see, that's what I'm saying. If they don't motion him in, you think he's still coming?
That's what I'm asking. If Bama doesn't motion 11 in, what happens?
I think it's still blitz.
Yeah, but from,
because look at this.
But he's gonna be blitzing from the number
top.
Yeah,
he's dropping back. And he's coming here, and he knows he's got him.
Yeah, but
he's not getting home then. He's not getting home then.
He may not get home.
This safety, he's still got inside leverage. Watch when we, like right at this point. See, he's still inside. You've got this whole area open.
Right.
There had to be some kind of miscommunication between the corner and the safety, because this safety would never be this far in. And we saw it after the play starts. He goes right here. And now they're doubling this guy.
And nobody's on 11.
No, right. Nobody's on 11, right. And nobody's on the back.
So that's what I'm saying.
He's trying to get to the back. He just gets picked.
You think so?
Watch him.
Well, then, but if you know you have the back, you get outside leverage.
Yeah. Watch him, though. Get through it.
Yep.
See, he's trying to get there.
Yeah. It's interesting. What a huge play.
It was a huge play, wasn't it?
2:10 left.
Absolutely. They're coming down the field, like, managing sort of the things they want. Right. And now that happens?
Well, now if you're Nick Saban, the thing you didn't want, your defense is back on the field, 2 minutes left.
It's a big spot.
And they got to stand up. Yeah, and if you're Dabo, right now, if I'm Dabo, I'm trying to go score again.
Oh, right. Oh, absolutely.
Hell yeah.
See, and this is where they're not as good.
But here's the thing, though. Tua, incredible year. 41 touchdowns, 4 interceptions, right?
Yeah.
Even going back to Nash Jim Tua.
Yeah.
2 really bad interceptions.
Oh, yeah.
Right? He's not seeing the field. He didn't see that blitz.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, he had the big play on the double move.
Wait. You're not suggesting the ultimate Hollywood script flip here, are you? That halftime a year ago, you're not suggesting that it comes full circle.
I think that the Ravens should have gone. Maybe call
Flacco. They go Joe Flacco.
I'm not saying.
You're saying Jalen Hurts.
No, I'm not. I would not
McShay?
Do that.
No,
because this Alabama's team is so explosive on the outside.
Yeah. Oh, and they need it.
And he knows the guy who can provide that. Yeah.
2 minute drill. Usually the first play, you want to try to get something explosive.
Ooh.
And you got it.
Gets there.
And they got it, yeah.
Yeah.
Now,
and it gets there.
Now as a play caller, you can get rolling. Okay.
I know they're going to go temp. They're going to go pace here, but just give me a peek here.
Look at it.
Give me a peek of the ball coming out.
He's throwing this corner route. But look at him. He's standing on the opposite hash. Yep. Hash marks are obviously wider in college
he's
football.
He's got that arm.
Look at that. I mean, that's a 27-yard throw on the sideline.
And he knows he's got to have the trajectory low to get it there in time before.
I mean, that's a heck of a
more
throw.
Years to talk about him. Look at the time.
Again. He's letting that thing rip.
Did you do Clemson games this year?
We too. The Duke game and then the South Carolina back-to-back.
Yeah.
They struggled a little bit offensively.
What's the kid like when you sit with him?
He's a freshman. They don't let freshmen sit.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Then we start quarterbacks.
Everyone just raves about him.
How about that high school stats? Those high school stats there. 161 touchdowns.
13,000 yards.
21 interceptions.
Alabama got 5 in the box.
I'd run it.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'd run it right now. He's checking. Play clock's down to 7.
We only have one timeout.
One timeout remaining.
I know it.
We got a minute 53.
Come on, kid. Snap it.
Well, that's a bad burn of the timeout right there. Man. That's not how you want to use your last timeout right there. This is a big swing moment.
This drive.
Drive right here is a big, because you got Bama was going to go. Remember, I just said to you, go. He'll take 28-23, knowing you're getting the ball. Then you know that could have been a swing for Bama. Get 2 scores back to back. knowing you're getting the ball. If they get any points out of this, that's a massive swing.
With 153, though, you got plenty of time with the first downs. I mean, if I'm Dapo, obviously this goes without saying, I'm still aggressive. Mm-hmm. I don't want to kick a field goal. That's only two possessions game still.
Right. All right.
Get a touchdown.
Yep.
Make it a three-possession game going in halftime.
That would be unbelievable.
Yeah. But you like to see the freshman. I mean, I want him to be smart. Don't turn it over. I'm with you. Yeah, we'll take field goal. We're feeling good.
Let's stay aggressive.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's be smart.
I just think you don't abandon the run here. I mean, it was a light box. Run the football. I'm not sure what the confusion is all about.
He's covered up. So he's coming this way. If I'm running, I'm going this way. I think they're going to stay with the pass.
Knowing that he's blitzing off the edge there.
Who, five?
Number five. Yeah,
he
backed into coverage.
Look at that throw.
Jeez.
And he gets out.
And he gets
past midfield. Flag. What's the flag?
Yeah, 15 yards. Late out of bounds.
15 yards with the late. That's the freshman, Ross.
Watch this ball come out of his hand.
The receiver here, Whit. That's that Ross kid.
He's not even perfectly set either. Look at his feet.
Yeah, that's a great throw. But look at my man, Ross. Go back.
Yep.
Watch him run this route.
Freshman.
Yeah, he's going to go up, hard stick, and then come out of it. He doesn't lose ground at the top of this route.
This plus 15, though, is
start
brutal.
At the top of the play, McTay.
Yep.
Watch his route, though.
All right. Freeze it. Freeze it once he gets it at the top of his drop.
Yep.
Right there. Freeze it. Look at that pocket. Come on now. If you're Nick Saban, the one thing we wanted to do with this kid
is pressure him.
Was pressure.
Move him off the spot.
Man, look at that pocket.
Yeah.
I mean, I could throw from that pocket.
With this, he's inside of him still and then comes back out.
It's a second cut.
I got to start training for that. Mm. Here he comes. Here comes his ball. Oh, he got it. Free play. Throw it. Throw it up. There you go, kid.
Nice job.
Almost got something out of it.
Yeah.
You want to have a stupid conversation?
I love that they keep the free play.
Yeah.
In college. They took it out
in pro football.
Kentucky, North Carolina, and Duke, and we were in the one-and-done world, knowing how thin this coming draft is on that side of the ball.
Who are you talking about?
Where would he be in this class? Where would he be in spring class?
He would be the first quarterback.
So, and where would he go?
He would go to a team like the Giants or the Jaguars, trading up to number one.
So as a true freshman, he'd be coming out, and he'd be a top 10 pick.
I believe it. And I think Tua would be the same.
Now look at this drive.
Oh, he's hot.
Look at this drive. How big is that third down cat?
I love
his release. Remember the first two throws he had?
Love his release.
He looked rushed.
Oh. Well, the third one, when they came back for the second possession, they just tried to get him the receiver screen just to get a completion, and he puts it 5 feet over his head.
Those throws compared to this.
How about what this drive is going to do to the scoreboard?
Have we seen Christian Miller tonight for Alabama, guys?
No.
Okay, so if we haven't seen him, there's 92 making a play. Hello.
Speaking of the draft.
I see you.
Yeah.
All right, big fella, get back in the huddle.
You're down by 12. Let's get back.
Oh, you can't make a play and then go to the sideline. Come on. That's like the D-line Maru. We don't make a play and then go sit down and get water.
You know, like this, though. Look, he's got the double team on him.
Yeah, I mean, that's just, 59, that's terrible. I mean, if you got a double team, go ahead and double team the guy.
What are we waiting on, Clemson?
Got sold.
We're doing a good job kind of wiring those
down and 12 now.
Here's
your third and 12.
Would have been physical, disrupting the timing of the play.
And they've gone away from those stack formations, too.
I'm just thinking right now, one-on-one at the bottom of the screen, I realize that Savion Smith and Patrick Surtain are new corners. It's the weakness of this defense. I'm trying to get something outside.
You got 2 6-4 receivers out on the outside.
Yeah,
and you got a guy
there's
here.
There's a stack release. There's a stack release.
Who comes up and produces on third down.
Both 6-4 receivers.
Yeah, I'm throwing to the outside, man. I'm going to challenge these corners.
Got your back. Oh, keep running.
He could have walked in almost.
They missed the protection. These guys both blitz. Both of them blitz. He's got him, but he pulls up. Watch it.
Who's that running back?
Oh, he just threw it in the air. He walked. Oh.
Feaster
28. That's a good angle.
That was 26.
He just wants it quick.
Adam Choice.
That's when you got a lob with touch and just throw it in the air. Let it run under.
It's a good play call, too, because they're clearing it out with these two.
They don't carry it.
And they swing them around.
Yeah.
Take the three. Yeah.
Down 15 at halftime. 31 on Nick Saban.
Had the ball.
24.
Third down.
Yeah.
Had the ball. Third down.
14 of them. Well, no, seven of them.
What was it? Yeah. What was the third? What was the distance on that third down? Third and what? When the cat?
I want to say 14. The last one? Oh no.
No, when Bama had the ball, the third down. What was it? Third and what? When he came
third
with
third and seven.
Yeah. Third and seven. To your punting, you don't get off a good punt. Wasn't even inside the 20. They come right down the field. Now you're down by 15.
Yeah.
You're trying to make that thing 28-23 is what you were looking for.
Yeah.
And you now it's 31-16.
But if I'm Nick, I go in the half and say, guys, take a deep breath. Look, the two interceptions crushes. We're running the football against these guys.
Right.
Right? Right? They're not stopping us.
Right.
What's the average yards per rush, Tony G?
I think they're still close to five.
They got maybe they're over five.
4.6.
Okay.
Right.
You take that against this front.
Yeah, so 5 yards. 5 yards per carry. Yeah. Trailed by 2 scores last year against Georgia at the half when he pulled the trigger on the quarterback.
With the college rules, though, 45 seconds left.
Oh, 45 seconds.
Three timeouts. Plenty of time.
No doubt, Book.
You let Tua keep throwing.
I agree.
Clemson's defense gives up 92 yards a game.
Yeah.
Got 112?
Yeah.
113 already?
Oh, here's a good stat.
What
you ready for this?
Give me a nugget. Give me some
guy. Tony G.
I was hoping it was a chicken nugget, but I'll take a regular nugget.
Lawrence, 107 yards passing on third down. Tua,
zero. Wow.
Huge stat.
Wow.
Oh.
Oh, don't do it.
What was that?
Yeah.
Is that a 15? Nothing? Just
nah.
Let him play. That's what that is. You're talking noise to him now. Look at Big Daddy. Big Daddy's talking noise. Tip balls in zone coverage. Usually a pick.
He's lucky that ball didn't go in the air further.
Yeah.
14's coming up with that ball.
Christian Wilkinson's been quiet today. Haven't really heard much from Big Wilkins.
I don't like this front. Look at him. There's no safety in the back.
Yeah.
Nobody back here. This is all out blitz.
He's going to drop.
And he's checking.
He's going to drop somebody.
He's got to. He's checking.
You're up 15.
Yeah, they got to bail. There they go.
He bailed.
Trying to bait him into a throw. Smart by Tua. He tried to run it.
There's Wilkins.
But just look at the cat and mouse game. To Whit's point, all out blitz. And what did Tua do? He started checking all go. All go. Let's go.
Yeah.
And then.
But he knew he was going to bait him into that.
Yeah, and Clemson checked. And he drops back. He has nowhere to throw the ball.
You like running the clock out here, Burke?
Yeah, you run it out. Let's move on. 31-16. Let's move on. There's nothing good that's going to happen right now. If you're Alabama, let's move on. Clemson is hype. Now, Nick Saban is the greatest coach of all time. Let's go make some adjustments.
Yeah.
Because Trevor Lawrence.
Turnovers.
Turnovers, and you got to figure out Lawrence.
Defense, yeah.
Right.
Secondary.
Bama gets it. To start the second half.
Yep.
We're going to take a quick break. We're going to come back. We're going to give you all the halftime festivities. Do you want to see bands?
I want to get some.
We got bands. We got food. This guy's going to fit. He's going to fit.
I just need something. Yeah.
Stick around.
Me.
Halftime. Coming up.
Yeah.
Quick break.
I got one stuck in my throat. Football film room.
At the College Football Playoff National Championship. This is part of the mega cast. You're watching the Monday Night Football Film Room. I'm Joe Tessitore. That's Booger McFarland. That is Jason Witten. And our NFL draft guru, Todd McShay, who started the night dominating on the clicker and the telly, and now we've got split duties over here.
Here's what happened. I was struggling doing both. First, had it back here. We made an adjustment. You're doing a lot more of the circling. I've got the remote, and we're rolling.
It's teamwork.
We need to make in-game adjustments.
If you had him as your tight end at Richmond, your career would have been completely different.
Who knows where I'd be today.
You would have been fourth string, Arena Football League 2.
Yeah.
It would have been phenomenal.
It would have actually ruined my career.
Matt Nagy.
It would have gotten you a pro.
It could have been Matt Nagy.
Yeah.
But
that's
guys,
exactly
correct. Arena Football League career.
BU, baby. BU.
Anyways, we got 31-16. Boog, your quickest takeaway. What do you got?
I'm looking at the halftime food. Let's start there.
Well, you don't want that as a takeaway.
Well,
now,
I'm just this is my first of all. The game is 31-16. I think we all understand right now. Sunshine is playing a really,
Trevor
really good
Lawrence.
Game. Yeah, Sunshine is playing a really good game. I'm just concerned if you're at home right now and you're watching this game and you're tuned to us, first of all, thank you. Second of all,
you're thanking all our family members.
Second of all,
my wife's got it on every television. Please. It's helping the ratings.
Hey, I got honey turkey breast. I got a chicken breast that was cooked this morning.
You ever played minor league baseball?
I mean, minor league. Listen,
it's on the back of the bus. Hey, like
those carrots don't look good. Oh, they don't look right, man.
I mean, where are the wings at? Can somebody
you may break a tooth on that carrot now?
I mean, can somebody get some wings in here? Just dry, boneless. I mean, anything. It doesn't matter.
Send somebody out.
Yeah, he's got cash.
Well, the problem is there's not even concessions on that level. This is like the corporate suite level, and we got no juice to like barge in.
I mean, I'm taking turkey and folding it up to make nuggets. That's what I'm doing.
Speaking of taking something, takeaways. The two interceptions by Clemson, A.J. Terrell, the pick six. Let's go through it a little bit. Let's show you that first one. This is how the game started off with the 44-yard interception return by A.J. Terrell. I don't see it at all. I think they need to put program on. McShay, what are you doing over there? You got a program button there? Here it is.
There we go. See you, T-Mac.
Well, he just came off of it there on the blitz. Yeah. You know, he was able to see it.
But you say they baited them here,
both
right?
Both interceptions were against five or more rushers. We thought they were going to pressure Trevor Lawrence.
Well, he sent six there. They both came up in the A-gap.
And that one was on Tua. That one was on Tua.
He just got greedy.
And then the big play towards the end of the half when they wound up having to punt the ball back and it resulted in 3 points for Clemson was, listen, it was another pressure. I don't know whether it was on Tua. That's a really difficult read to make, and he tried to get the ball to the right side. But his three mistakes in this game that have been costly and resulted in points have been against pressure, five or more pressures.
But the biggest thing for Clemson today and tonight is really, look at that stat line, 31 points. They only had the time of possession for 10 minutes and 34 seconds.
Yeah, explosive.
So half as much time.
So the two interceptions are huge. But then the big play that Clemson's getting from the quarterback, Lawrence, that's a huge part of why they're up 31-16.
He settled down so beautifully after the way he started up, you know, freshman, obviously, on this kind of a stage.
And I think the first – we always talk about in basketball, you know, the first 5 minutes of the third quarter, right. Football, the first drive. This drive here – for Alabama and Tua, I think it's critical. Because you don't want to give the ball back three and out or a quick series and give the ball back to Sunshine and put your defense back on the field.
I'm interested to see what adjustments they make,
what do you
too,
expect?
Offensively. I think they're going to try to run the football as long as they keep it to this score or less. I don't think they're going to get away from it.
I think they're going to run the ball and then get his RPO game going.
Yeah.
Yeah.
His interceptions, the second one was where he's trying to force it down the field. That'll come. Right. He did throw a touchdown pass doing that as well. Right. So those plays will come. Run it. Get his run RPO game going. Allow some of these dynamic receivers to do it with the run after catch. Cut it to one possession. You're back in it. Nick Saban knows that.
And by RPO, you're talking about what they've done so well against Oklahoma, the slants,
right.
The inside quick game, putting the linebackers in a bind.
Right.
To me, that's what I agree with you on.
Yeah.
Boog, you're not hungry anymore?
By the way,
this side of the table is an absolute mess. Yeah. I mean, it's like debris everywhere. It is like.
Most of it's yours.
I did knock your coffee cup over during break, too.
This was unbelievable.
How did that recruiting process go for Lawrence? With Dabo to get him there?
Good question. I actually have this answer. We talked to him about it when we visited with him. He won't offer kids unless he has sat down and met with them and talked to them, especially at the quarterback position. Usually, you know, assistant coaches are allowed to go out and offer, and they do it in eighth grade. Like you were talking to the story about Don Brown and different guys. He wants to wait, ideally, until they're a sophomore. He's only made a couple of exceptions. He was one of them, but he wanted him to come into his office and spend time and get to know him a little bit and at least have that one-on-one connection. So he was on him early, and then he said when he went and visited with him that, you know, he was offered by a ton of different schools. But he was honest with him that he wasn't going to offer him early and just to be patient. And he appreciated that honesty, Lawrence did. And when it came down to it and some of the other schools, he was like, you know, Dabo was honest, and then he went through with his word, and then Ultimately, he just appreciated that.
Who was his second choice? Do we know? Well,
but Hunter Johnson was already in the program, who had been the number one recruit the year
before. That's right.
And then he transferred out.
Right.
And blast this right through the end zone. All right. So you say run the ball here on this first possession.
Stick to the game
stick
plan.
Stick to the run,
in.
And then it's going to play action will come off of it.
Yep.
Yep. And, Boog, critical that you come away with points here.
Well, I think if you're Alabama, it is critical. Because the weakness of your team so far has shown, which has been if the pass rush doesn't get there, no Christian Miller tonight.
Right.
Quinnen Williams isn't getting to the quarterback so far. The secondary on the back end, particularly the corners, are getting exposed. So you don't want to put them back on the field right
here. Here we go. Here we go. See if he gets the Harris here.
There we go.
Oh, nice run.
Just a missed tackle, though.
The missed tackle. Perfect way to start the second half for Bama, though.
Yeah, but if you're Venables, don't panic. The guy just missed a tackle. I mean, the defense was good. You just missed a tackle.
For them, they actually got to go ahead.
Yep.
They pulled the tackle trap around.
And 34 has missed, like, three tackles tonight already. Kendall Joseph.
That's a nice little cut, too.
Yeah, it is.
Just a little,
but don't slow your feet down. Shoot your gun. That's what we're taught as defenders. Don't start. You shoot your gun, and you do it full speed.
Coming off the edge?
Yeah, he's coming.
Another big run.
Nobody outside.
Yep. That's exactly what you said. You said strip the first two plays.
Yeah, he's going to come out
wrong. Yeah.
Who's got contain, though? That's my concern.
Yeah. Well, he went inside.
Farrell.
Yeah, he jumped inside. It's the clowny. It's just like clowny.
Yeah, exactly.
He jumps inside. Watch him.
He's got outside help.
Stay outside, son.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, you got to get outside.
Gives him that entire.
That's the difference between a 2 yard gain and 12.
And you had the pressure coming off the weak side.
Yeah, you got to get contained.
Yeah.
And now RPO. The RPO.
There it is.
Boom.
And it makes it easy now.
Flag.
But they finally called the lineman
what's
going
the flag?
Downfield.
What's the flag?
That's the penalty. Finally plus. Called. Watch his center.
College football, they never call this.
It's
3 yards?
It's a left tackle. It's your guy, Boog. He's up here running the RPO.
Yeah. Jonah.
Williams. They finally call him on it. Watch him.
Oh, he's my God.
Yeah, but this is what college football has been for a decade.
Yeah, but you, receiver downfield. Yeah, but you got to call that. So this is.
You know how much that goes uncalled in college football?
But he's
6 yards down the field.
He's 7 yards.
3-4, the number
three. It's a gray
three
area yards. Of 3 yards. Yeah. NFL, it's one, obviously, and you're going to get called easily. Yeah. Instantly, you get it called in the NFL.
But I see every single week.
Four
yards, close to five.
I think Gus Malzahn got paid for the first contract. Every Auburn offensive lineman was 7, 8, 9 yards downfield because nobody had picked up on it yet.
Bootleg.
He's got the over.
He's got it. Yeah,
there it is.
He took the field.
Make a tackle.
Nice move.
He's so good after
Irv
that.
Smith. Yeah, his father was great.
He could be the first tight end taken.
He is. Yeah. Really, like where? Well, it's tight end, so you
know. Top 35, top 40.
So late first, early second.
Right, exactly.
It's amazing. Wait, what are you seeing him?
He's athletic. He's really good after the catch, reliable hands, and he started to block a little bit better, too. He's not a great blocker.
He did.
Against Oklahoma.
Yeah, he's been more consistent with it.
Oh.
But take that back, though, Mitchell, on that play right there. Watch Tua cock it as far as the ball. Like, he's wanting to take a shot here. He's going to come over here and get back, and he's wanting to let that ball go right there.
I don't know where he's going to let it go.
That's what I'm saying.
But was he looking at the tight end?
Yeah, he was wanting to look deep, but he thought better of it, and he just threw it out of bounds. But you could tell, like, he's a guy that wants to throw the football deep. And that's the one criticism everybody has of him. He wants to take the big play, the greedy play. He has trouble just taking the 5-10, take the check down.
Yeah, he's not Johnny Manziel, but he's got some of that in him.
Yeah, wildcat. A little bit.
Every third and one, he's gone wildcat.
Yeah, and they haven't stopped it, though.
But you got to slant to the wildcat, though. That's the thing about it.
That was their best effort of fitting it. They're going to mark him short.
Yeah, and you do it again if you're Nick Saban.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, they were, like you said.
But the other two times, they ran the power
scheme. They're slanting towards it.
That's what you should do.
Scheme, and now they're running the zone scheme with
it. But slant. There you go. Slant down. That's what you have to do. Because essentially, the reason teams run wildcat, guys, is because you're a man short.
Right.
Okay, so it's a quarterback run. You don't account for the quarterback.
Right.
And so if you're a defense, you got to figure out a way to get the extra man.
This is the third, fourth, and one where Nick's gone for it.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
Nice slow walk of that chain for the measure.
When you've given up 31.
Yeah.
when they've only had the ball for 10 minutes.
He might have that one. Oh, credit card.
No, Gene Serator.
Credit card.
Put the no card.
Here we go. Let's slide it in there. Hey, let's open it up right here.
Yeah. Let's see if we can hear the story about Gene Serator. Dallas against Seattle.
Oakland.
What is
Dallas against
Oakland. Excuse me. Yeah. 4th and 1. Oh, yeah. This guy, what a.
You talked to Gene, didn't you?
I'll tell you after.
I said, so you actually had a conversation with Gene.
Yeah.
He's up in the broadcast.
Wildcat now, again. If I'm Clemson, I'm slanting my defensive line to the tight end.
They're going to pull the guard around. They're going to run the power.
Yeah.
Strong right side here.
I'm slanting toward 84.
I'm running boundary.
There they go.
There it is.
But you saw it, though. Boom, right there.
Oh, he did.
I got it.
But maybe.
Yeah.
High end zone. Mitchell, high end zone. Watch the defensive line. Watch 42. Go back. Watch 42. Slanting sure toward. There he is. Boom. 42 slanting toward the tight end there, 84, and he knocks off the puller. Now you just got to make the tackle, 47.
Circle 42 for me, will you?
Right there. 42. Watch him slant. Yeah, boom. Right there. You slant toward the tight end. All right, because you got to create penetration because you're a man short when the Wildcat quarterback, therefore the running back, has the ball.
That was a good effort, though, on that run.
Go get him. Go get him.
Step up. Oh, he had Judy.
Yeah, a lot of people there.
But he had Judy.
He got him on the dig. Circle Judy for him.
I think it's one of these two guys.
He was right here, wasn't he?
He's number three.
Yeah, but watch
him. He runs the dig. He lines up here. He's going to come in.
He's got that guy. No, and he's got Judy for a touchdown.
Judy.
Yeah. Oh, Judy was wide.
He's got Judy for a touchdown.
Oh, man.
That's what I'm saying.
But the problem on this, watch his back. His back comes over here. He's supposed to play fake.
Correct. The play fake is to the wrong side.
Yeah, back goes.
And he would have picked up the protection if he was on the left side.
Get outside. Somebody got a field.
Good lane.
This guy's running hard.
Isn't he?
Yeah.
It's like they split up
a different gear tonight. This half.
Yeah. Jacobs got more of the work in the first half, didn't he? They started spreading around first, but Jacobs in the second quarter.
I think it was pretty split.
Yeah.
Watch, though, how they're playing this mid-zone. So they're really pushing them. Watch the right tackle make this block. It's about displacement. Boom.
They throw him out,
right? It creates that lane.
Yeah, that was nice.
Good displacement by him.
Yeah.
To create a lane for him to run inside.
Yeah. Jedrick Wills.
A little wide split out past the numbers.
Yeah. All you're trying to do is just create space out there. Create
go. Just get north and south.
Just coming down the field little by little.
But you got to. This is where they've got to finish.
Oh, it's got to be 7.
It's got to be.
Yeah, this got to be 7.
They've done a lot of this tonight.
Yeah.
320 yards.
Right.
And 16 points. Yeah.
Does he have one completion? How many plays in this drive here? But, gee, how many plays on this drive, buddy? 9th play.
How many runs?
7.
It's a 9-play, 49-yard drive right now.
Good tackle.
Kept it in front. Yep.
That's okay. Now it's 7-6.
Mullins played nice tonight. Yeah.
Good bunch of these guys up.
Rushing yards is Bama 148 to Clemson 27.
I think it looks like Clemson's playing a lot more man than they expected. That's why the RPOs haven't.
Yep.
See? They're all manned up.
But that's how you take away the slants, though. Man-to-man and the RPO.
The RPO.
Yeah.
Exactly. Straight drop.
Don't you?
That's okay. Now it's 33. Ball came out. Get the ball.
Oh. He's down.
They're ruling that a fumble.
Yeah. Interesting to see here. The Saban challenge that because they lost 2 yards on the fumble.
Yep. They're saying Smith fumbled.
Let's see if the ball... No, that may be out.
Give me yards over here.
Yeah, so they lost 2 yards. Is the ball coming out? I don't know.
Well, here we go. What are you looking for here?
I think same thing. I think we're going to see crossing routes.
Yeah.
There you go.
Ruling on the previous play was the runner fumbled the ball before
he
was down.
Yeah, so I'm saying, so Nick lost 2 yards.
Right.
So if I'm him, I challenge that. You get the 2 yards back. Now instead of 3rd and 7, it's 3rd and 4, 3rd and 5.
Work that magic there, McShay, will you please?
You want to watch the fumble?
I don't care what you watch. Just talk ball with me, will you please? Bring it. Bring your best stuff right now. I love that. I love the right tackle what you showed there. What?
You like that?
Yeah.
Hey, what's the address if we call Uber Eats? Is it this Levi Stadium?
Levi Stadium. Yeah.
Good luck.
That would be a great. Will Uber Eats deliver to the national championship?
I'm just trying to see if we can get somebody in the vicinity.
So on these plays, yeah. he's the whole player, and he's got him man to man. He needs to drive on these crossing routes. He does fumble it though.
You think it's a fumble?
Instead, watch. Nobody covers here. See what I'm saying?
That's the third time tonight. He's had his back open.
He doesn't even look that way though. Look at him.
Well, they're playing. You see here. He's going with them. They're playing man. They're playing man on this side.
He's got the back. He's lost. He needs to go right here.
It was a complete breakdown.
Yeah. So, I mean, that's a walk-in if he hits the back.
Let's watch it from the...
Yeah, so we can see the back when he gets out there in space.
Jeez.
Look at this. He's got the touchdown. He throws that.
Yeah, because they're going underneath here.
Safety's inside the ashes.
And the back just doesn't see it.
Yeah, he didn't take it.
Oh, wow.
His first responsibility for Damian Harris, the running back, is to see if anyone's coming on the blitz.
Yeah.
The linebacker doesn't come. There's nobody there. And you see how quickly he's going to peel out.
Yeah, they call it a check release.
Yeah,
he's
exactly.
Checking in release. A little check release.
What down was that?
Second.
That so was third and six?
So third and four or third and six.
With what they ruled on the field, it's third and six.
Correct. Correct.
What are you doing on third and six here?
Well, they've had the best completions have been on these crossing routes. So I do it again. I worry about that with Tua, though. Like, I want to see him read defenses.
Yeah.
You know, when you start talking about the next level and going to the NFL, like, yeah. You can't miss that on the back. It's tight man-to-man. Yeah, he is very accurate. From the pocket. He can make the big throws. But, you know, you got to one, two, three.
And the thing is, he's been really good at that. Sure.
Yeah, he has.
He's been
but
good
not
at
tonight.
That. No,
he hasn't missed the been corner tonight. Blitz, which is a tough one.
Right.
He missed the coverage
Didn't
there.
His quarterback draft again?
Dwayne Haskins from Ohio State.
Haskins is one. You got Daniel Jones from
Duke.
Who I think is a little bit overrated. Long levered. Yeah, I do. I think
he's a long guy. He's
Jones, like Jones or Ryan Finley? Which one you
and
like?
Finley from NC State, your third?
Yeah, I would take Finley.
He's a smart kid.
Yeah, he'll be an adequate starter or a great backup, but he will get the game.
But you think Haskins can be a star?
Yeah, I think
they're going to do the same thing. They're going to run the hook, swing, flat, or drag.
If you're Loxley, you've got to be in his head about
third and six. Yeah.
Here they come. Just simple full.
Dropping.
Good coverage.
That's just good D.
Good coverage.
Now, remember what we were talking. Now you got fourth down.
And that's fourth and six. You got to kick it right now.
Yeah, but remember what I was
saying. That's a corner going up against a bigger tight end here.
Fourth and six. You got to kick it. You got to kick it.
He just isolated that.
He might drive out there a little early. That's a good catch. I mean, good coverage, I mean.
So here you go.
All right, Tez, give it to me. Well, break down the form. Here we go.
He doesn't lift well. He's all right. Feeble, and then he punched just to get the last one through. So he's probably going to strike a low ball here and not get enough lift and clean it. Let's see.
Hey.
Oh what a call.
Right, that tells you. I mean, that tells you so much.
But why are they running up? Up the middle.
I would just rather go for it on fourth.
Look at Nick. Oh, look at Nick.
By the way, what are we doing?
Is
your lead blocker.
I hate the call.
I hate the call.
I didn't even mind you going for it.
Take the point. Do something different.
Yes, go for it. Yes, I hate the call. First of all, you're not getting outside. And then.
Give me that high end zone, McShay.
There's no option
the same
to
angle
throw
we
the ball.
Saw.
There's nothing.
Yeah. Let's take a look at this.
They're running a power running
the kicker
power draw
lead.
With the kicker
with the
as
kicker
your
lead.
Yeah.
With your kicker as lead.
Yeah. Let's take a look at that from the high. Yeah, right here.
You know, run speed option.
Here's my thing, though. Kicker. They're in right, base defense.
So yeah. Watch the
they're
double.
In base defense. Base. They're yeah. Saying it safe. You got to call that off.
Right.
Off. You got to
right.
call that
it's off. It's
off
when you go base defense.
Once but they're in base.
Look at the effort, though.
Call that off and burn
look at the effort by 70 and 79. Left guard, left tackle. They're trying to double team. But just look at that effort. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, what are you
also,
doing?
What's it?
He just splits them. He comes right here and just splits him.
But look at the
long snapper
though.
Doesn't do anything.
I get
it. Jogging towards the line.
Hold up, though. Watch 33 and 99. They're blocking field goal. Watch them.
Yeah, they don't. What happens on a lot of those, they don't tell anybody except the kicker.
Third string quarterback.
Yeah.
On the right side. But those guys are going downfield, so you know they knew.
But, again,
but here's my thing. When they line up like this.
Mac Jones rushing yards on the year, two carries, 6 yards.
When they line up in this defense, it's off.
Yeah.
I want to see.
It's got to be off. You got to throw a timeout right there.
You can't do that there. You know, can you go back to the third down play?
Hey, I'm going to tell you how you know it was a bad call. Bad call. My wife chimed in. That was a horrible thing. That's how you know it was bad.
But there's no option to get outside to push.
Right. Hey, right. Trust me. I hear that all the time in my flag football games.
Yeah.
I get in the car, go home. Okay. My wife will be like, hey, that was a terrible call. What were you calling on third down?
Also, they've seen this kid kick all year, right? And they know what they saw. The missed extra point and the punch field goal. You think they were really confident sending him out for a 40-something yarder right there?
When you go safe defense, it's off.
It's off.
Who has a kick? Who has a field goal? Fake field goal on a safe. Here's my point on this. So this guy, one of the things that Venables does that gives you challenges, and third and six, I always think it's tough because they're running the basic high school slide protection, right? So they're going to put their back on a defensive end. See that book? That means the ball's got to come out.
Right.
And I just think in third and six, I don't love the call because now we got our back going against a defensive end. Watch it play out.
Yeah, because the tight end.
They all slide. Now he tries to. Everybody's just going there. And so you really get two man route, and they kind of double him up top there.
Yeah. Right. It's a heck of a play, too.
Yeah, it was a great play by Fields.
But here's the thing, though. Like, if you think about this, and Nick Saban told a story on SportsCenter. He said in critical moments that they were talking about the lessons he learned in coaching. And he said in critical moments he learned to call players and not plays.
Yeah,
I'm not calling that.
You just had your hold on right player.
But that's my point. Yeah. You call a play for Irv Smith when you got the Biletnikoff winner and Jerry Jeudy.
Yeah.
All right.
How about you call a play for
Nick? Listen, that look
kicker.
That he looked at his special teams coach.
Kicker.
Like what happened?
I mean, this
right.
He trusts Mac Jones.
Right.
They line up and safe. You don't run it.
Right.
He carried the ball. That was Mac Jones who carried the ball there.
Two of the worst fake field goals I've ever seen from some of the best coaches. Right there with Nick, and then Pete Carroll. You guys remember the Pete Carroll one?
Yes, absolutely. All right, back to business now. So, what did we say about that opening drive? You have to come away with something.
Oh.
That's a good play. Anthony Jennings.
Yeah, and that's their third drive of 10-plus plays.
Hey, listen, going back, three drives of 10 or more plays, only 10 points
on
those drives.
Yeah, can't happen.
Cannot happen.
No. The other thing I would say this is if you don't trust the kicker, and you know, okay, we're not kicking field goals. If it's outside of 25 yards, we're not kicking it.
Right.
Then maybe I run it on third down there.
Instead of a fourth and short if it's
right. That's
still
right.
Which is why
so
when
now,
he.
I can get in fourth and two,
correct.
Fourth and three.
But we if we can see it here in a sterile room, and when he punches, misses the extra point, punches field goal, they know they're not going to attempt a long field goal with him.
If he reads it, he just can't get there. Watch here.
Yeah.
All right, big play. This, for Bama, this
you
got to
get him off the
field. Got to get him off.
You got to get him off the field. Get your offense back out there. We'll come up to the halfway point of the third quarter. Got to get him off
corner.
The field. Descending.
Hey, look at that.
He fell down.
Look at this.
He's injured.
Here's your play.
He's injured.
This is it right here. That's unbelievable now, ain't it?
Yeah.
Justin Ross.
He's
really bad.
Yeah, that's the freshman wide receiver.
Let's see what happens.
Sends everybody.
Which corner is that? Is that Savion Smith, number four?
Yes.
Is that four or two?
Yeah.
Four.
No, two's at the bottom.
Your screen. That's got to be
four.
That's 13.
So
four's in the top. Four's in the top. Playing press man.
Oh, what a release. I mean, a freshman was receiver. The number one thing you look when you have press coverage is patience. Watch him. He goes in, out, in, hard club, and then comes back inside.
Yeah.
Boom.
It's over.
It's good. That's really good.
That is really good.
You don't see that a lot.
No, and that's a really good
throw. And then we saw his routes earlier.
This is what this kid is.
He's something.
Isn't he?
He has come on strong.
Sign him up, man. This kid is something now.
Sign him up.
They list him at 210. He looks even bigger than that. 6'4", 210.
You know, the other part of this is, look at this throw.
Backing
away from it.
Yeah.
Knowing they're coming. I mean, that's it right there. So Bama opening drive comes down 10-plus plays, nothing, on a fake field goal into safe defense, and then they just turn right around and do that.
Yeah, they're coming. They send the blitz. You get five coming. And Anthony Jennings wins.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Can you go to the all 22?
That's Palmieri.
We're getting everybody's.
Audio guys, I don't care.
Yeah, I just thought it was interesting. He did a good job of looking off the safety.
That's right. Yeah.
You know, you watch his head. He's looking off the safety, which keeps Thompson away.
Yeah.
So Thompson's not able to go one side or the other.
Yeah.
And then I'll bring it back. What do you want? All 22?
Yeah.
All right, here we
go.
So
the one thing about Nick Saban, line one for Nick Saban, he has a stud into the boundary of the defense.
Yeah.
Because he knows that's where they want to go the ball a lot, right? And then he rolls over here, brings pressure to the field, and says, okay, can you throw 17-yard out routes
right.
to the field?
Right.
So have a lockdown guy.
Bring it. You just lost your audience.
Oh, man, my audience is shut down. This is Nick, Nick Saban. This is good stuff.
Yeah.
Have a lockdown guy here, bring pressure to the field, and make him make this throw. He's the guy that's the single coverage.
Right.
Right? But when you dominate, when you don't have that guy, Fitzpatrick, those type of guys aren't here, now he wins. It's tough, you know?
And this is – I don't want to – he probably is still going to get open, but this is a fluke play to get injured right there.
And now a position where you're already starting to question it.
Right.
Now they're lacking depth.
And they're carting Smith off the field,
so
too.
So Smith is done.
And so that's
your two starting corners is gone.
That's a bad injury for him, and I realize he's hurt. But let's not minimize that release.
Oh, it was unbelievable.
I mean, that's an unbelievable release. Yeah. Patience at the line of scrimmage. Most young
that's
receivers.
Why, remember when you asked earlier? Calvin Ridley.
Yeah.
You know, Ridley, from day one, knew how to release off the line, and it was a great route runner.
This kid Ross is going to be something.
Yeah. Oh.
Well, he already is.
Most receivers, it's like they're in high school, right? They just take that release. Whichever side you're going to give me, I'm going to take.
Right.
And then go. And they get wired up to the sideline.
Right.
Not here.
He dictated the turn.
Oh, yeah.
He's like, here's what I'm going to do to you, and you're going to deal with it.
I did not see 37-16.
How about Lawrence staying in there and
he's almost got he's almost got 300.
Yep. He's got 275.
You're going to call him Trevor then?
275
close.
To 2.
I mean, Witt said, would you say 400 or 4 touchdowns? 400,
Trevor Lawrence. Yeah.
I agree, though. If he could come out after 1 year, he would be the number one pick. I mean, just that size, that what he can potentially be or will be.
Yeah.
Boog, do you feel better that they got stadium concessions for you?
I'm getting there. Yeah,
smells good.
Yeah, it smells
you
better.
Want some
pepperoni pizza?
Pepperoni
some
pizza.
Pepperoni pizza.
It's hot. Yeah, here it's
go ahead,
hot.
Take whatever you want there.
Pepperoni pizza is hot.
You want some of that?
Yeah, it's nice and hot. Trust me.
Oh yeah.
Do you want a plate? You gonna put it right on your paper?
Yeah, I don't need that. I don't need those notes.
You're not carving it up.
No. That fake field goal. I cannot get over the fake.
Oh. But also. For it to come on a drive, we're all sitting here saying they got to come away with something. Look at this. What are we doing over here? We're just ricocheting things. We got an extra point missed on both.
Well, so that basically makes it a 3-4 game.
I'm ready. Give me a bag, bro.
Three touchdowns. You don't need a 2-point conversion.
Make you absolutely sick.
Oh, it's unbelievable. Watch him come across.
Let's go back and look at it.
Yeah. You don't want me to. You're really not looking for that. You don't want me. Okay. You want this, McShay? You really want this?
Of course I do.
Okay, go ahead. Let it play and then bring it back. Okay, watch the head and watch the left shoulder. Watch it. Watch this.
All right.
Watch the left shoulder. Watch the right. Okay, he's also. Okay, now watch. Let it go through.
He just swiped across?
Sort of like Top Golf the other day with fitting.
How do we get Top Golf in here?
I mean, it's not a 3 o'clock leg lock either.
Hey, I mean,
contact was off.
At this rate, I may catch an earlier flight. I mean, it's 37-16.
Oh man!
They've had the ball for 11 minutes and 55 seconds,
and they got 37 points.
Yeah. Pick sixes in there, but then big plays are in there too, right? Right. I mean, just think. Here's
14
plays.
Points off the turnovers.
Pick
Alabama
six
has none.
17-yard touchdown. Another couple long passes that set up one, and then you got a 74-yard touchdown. Yeah. Win probability, according to ESPN FPI. You like that FPI, Mitchell? You do the FPI?
They're
certain parts of it.
Okay, 98%.
Okay. 98%. We've seen it before. Let's not give up on this yet.
No, I'm not saying we go. I'm just giving facts. Cold hard facts. Yeah.
But at this point, sticking with the run and all that is basically out the window. Well, you can mix it in every once in a while.
When does the DEFCON 1 tweet go out?
Are we at DEFCON 1?
If you're down three scores in the second half, it's out. I just sent it out.
Did you send it out?
Yeah. Oh, DEFCON 1's out. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, you're down three scores, middle of the third quarter, it's out.
You just texted me? Oh, okay.
Dabo, the score is 0-0. Such coach speak.
Yeah.
The score is 0-0, man.
Yeah. It'd be interesting to see if Clemson continues to come after him to send pressure, because that's been what's successful for them tonight.
One back counter.
Of course, he comes out and runs.
Exactly.
But now are we going to see tempo?
Well, you have to. I mean, you got to play with some urgency, right? Don't you?
Yeah, you got to go tempo. Yeah.
And maybe it'll get him into a rhythm.
The problem is, in that defensive backfield right now, what's stopping the other side?
They've been outcoached, and you have to wonder if Loxley, the offensive coordinator, with all the time spent on Maryland, if that had it's affected him at all.
You think?
That seemingly happens every year in the game.
I don't think it affects him.
Yeah. You don't?
No. Because I just think Nick won't allow that to happen.
Right. There we go.
That's a good ball.
Nice in cut.
Show it to him.
Get to the line and go.
Yeah, get a little tempo. We're just playing that single high defense. That safety's coming down inside, so he knows he's going to come down in here.
He's coming over this way.
Yeah, and then he, boom, right in behind
him. Right.
The thing about it is you have to push it down the field because you can't run it at 10 yards because those linebackers are getting good depth.
Yeah, because it's dropping
down. So you have to push it to 15, 17 yards, which is what Alabama's doing.
Here we go. We're running on first down.
That's
Wilkins.
That's that same player earlier with a safety Muse.
Yep.
He's coming from depth.
Right here.
Yes. Yeah, so
him cheating.
Yeah, he's running into it. So it's basically, right now, it's 4-on-3. So you got four defenders for Clemson and only three blockers there for Alabama.
Yeah, he's an in-the-box player in this.
Yeah,
right.
I'd go right at him then. Because they're showing a two-shell to make you think run it.
Correct.
And he's coming down the fifth.
Correct.
And there's a part of you that says, okay, just run it in there. Let's see if he can make that tackle.
Right.
But if I'm down this much, I'm attacking. I'm throwing the ball down the field.
Yeah, single high again.
Yep.
Got him.
He's got to touch it, though. That was a nice pass.
That was a nice pass.
Nice little back shoulder up.
Yep. Really nice pass.
And again,
and that's the back out of the backfield.
Here he comes. He's coming down, so you got single high man-to-man.
Right. Right.
That's a really good throw.
Well, it's a good throw.
They just designed this.
Yeah.
Witt said that's his number one back.
Thank you.
Well, he's had a great game today.
Yeah. Now, this is where Clemson has really picked up their level in this game in the red zone.
Yep. I'm taking it.
Because
the safety's cheated over.
Goes inside.
That's okay. Make him earn it. Don't give him any big plays. It's 2nd and 5.
Yeah, he sees the corner coming.
Yeah, and that's the right call off that.
He jumped that too. He just couldn't get in there. He saw it coming.
What we got?
One back power again. Well, he played fast.
Got the slant.
Get the ball out.
Oh, he missed it.
Real high.
Rarely does that.
He does. He's usually accurate on something like that.
All right, Whit, here you go. 3rd and 4. This is obviously 4-down territory, so does that affect your play call here? I mean, it's 3rd and 4 now.
Yeah. I would run it and turn down to get it.
This is the right read.
Right, that's what I'm saying, yeah.
He just quicker with it.
Yeah.
Misses the throw.
Misses it. All right, 3rd and 4, you said?
Yeah, it's 3rd and 4. It's obviously 4-down territory.
Yep.
Look,
we're going to take a short break here, believe it or not. We're going to give you a moment to breathe.
Okay.
We're going to have a 3rd and 4 when we come back as Saban faces his largest deficit in his Bama career.
Welcome back, college football national championship. The Monday Night Football crew plus McShay. I don't know how I got thrown in here. With Booger McFarland, Jason Witten. Joe Tess will be with us momentarily.
Yeah, he went to the little boy's room.
Yeah,
he's had like 14 bottles of water.
He doesn't have the bladder he once had. But we got a big, this is a key spot.
Oh, yeah.
3rd down and 4. Alabama obviously is in 2-down territory. They're down 37-16.
Yeah.
they got to finish it.
Oh, no question.
It's been a problem all night.
Certainly it's four down territory. That's why I think you can run it. You can run the football in this situation knowing that you got four downs to go here.
Yep.
And Tua's just seemed off. He had a touchdown throw there on the RPO earlier. He just missed it.
Right.
But if you can score on this drive, there's a lot of time still.
It's still a quarter and a half. It's still a ball game.
Test this 16 bottles of water cut up to you. Oh, he's going back to his running back.
Ooh. Oh. Sure.
I think they thought they were going to bring it down again. Maybe that corner blitz was going to come and he was going to run the quick out.
Judy
got him on that corner blitz.
Yeah.
And now.
I kind of thought.
And now he did grab him.
But it's a good no call. Let him play. When you got the best athletes in college football on the field, let him play. Fourth down.
This is what they should have done the last fourth down. Keep the offense on the field.
I'm going drag, swing, and then get two slants.
All three of those defensive linemen that came back are right now rushing the pass. This is why you come back right now.
He ran the corner blitz again.
They didn't get him.
Oh, nice.
Oh, he didn't get there. Nice. Wow.
All right, show us that corner blitz, boys.
But that's the thing. So he comes down again. He's going to bring this corner blitz inside.
Nasty split.
Inside.
Watch this drag, though. He's got him. Watch him tuck it. Throw it right here.
Oh, wow.
Throw it.
Wow. Take it again. Clear that screen.
He had already.
Boom. Okay, you're going to go run.
Yeah.
Now throw it. You got him right here.
I don't know. Hold on.
Give it to me from high end zone, Mitchell.
No, I want to see Sky.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, Sky.
Yeah.
Now he's going to step back right. Watch him now.
Yeah, he could.
Start it over, though. All right.
But can he do that off the way he's running?
Yes, I understand it. Watch 42. Watch the twist game inside. Center, the twist game inside. He sees Lawrence coming. All right, linebacker's coming. 34's coming.
And the corner.
Yeah, exactly. Corner's coming. And it's the same blitz they ran earlier.
Yep. Yeah. But Tua did a good job of escaping. Now throw it.
Yeah.
He sees him even after he tucks it
on. His eyes are dropped, right?
Yeah.
Right there.
There.
Going. Yeah.
Now keep going. Running. Keep going a little bit. He still can throw it.
Yeah.
Oh, yes, right there. He absolutely can throw it.
Well,
he's tucked at that point, but he still could, yeah.
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 He's coming off the most efficient game he's played all year.
So he escapes good. Good job. Now throw it right there.
He has looked like a different quarterback. The pressure all night. It's been 5-6 man pressures that have gotten to him.
Right.
Venables versus Loxley is the theme of the night.
No question.
That is what is happening here, right?
Look at the back shoulder.
This is not strictly. This is not a talent gap. This is not.
No.
What with the exception of the Clemson wide receivers versus the Alabama defensive backs.
There is a talent gap right now. We talked about that at the beginning of the game.
Yes.
Yeah. All right.
There is a talent gap.
Now they're on their third cornerback.
Right.
The Savion's gone, so now you got Surtain Jr. And whoever the third corner is out there.
I'm
interested to get your thought on this. They teach at Clemson their receivers run the first 6 yards to win.
Right.
And then it's your job, as a receiver, to look back and adjust the ball, whether it's down the field or not. Huh. So he runs the first 6 yards to win. I haven't heard a lot of people coach it this way.
Yeah.
So it's 6 yards to win and then get the ball. The quarterback's going to make the decision. The receiver has to adjust to the ball.
Yeah, I love that. And what I think happens is because a lot of people play that press bail.
Yep.
And so then it's like, I'm going to run the fade, and now they're bailing.
Right.
You know, so now you go through 6 yards.
And then look back. You're looking back at the quarterback, and you're going to see where the ball's going.
That's right.
Clemson has 37 plays, and they have 37 points.
Pretty efficient, huh?
Good movement on the right side. Boy, it's an attractive target, but you got to get it to him.
You know, you guys have mentioned the mismatch. The mismatch of the receivers against Alabama's defensive backs.
Yeah.
Listen to this stat. 19.1 yards at completion.
Oh, wow. That's absurd.
19 against Nick Saban's defense?
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
And the biggest thing, too, they've been in the red zone now 3 times. They've only got one score on it, Alabama.
Yeah.
You know? Meanwhile, Clemson's 3-for-4.
There's been very little pressure.
There he goes.
Look at this. Look at this ball.
Look at this ball.
Hey, listen.
Just send them.
There's been a lot of great quarterbacks
and young quarterbacks at that. And Tua is.
Watch this.
But watch this throw by him. And see the coverage.
But look at the catch, the adjustment, though.
Yeah.
Oh, no question. But yeah. Now he knows. When he sees this safe, this first
safe. Yeah, he knows he's got one-on-one.
He's got one-on-one. It's an easy read.
It's 3rd and 13. Why are you in that?
It looks like a breakdown.
Again, though, Nick Saban. Into the boundary. Single high coverage. Yeah. Press coverage. Yeah. We need one lockdown defender. Then what does he do? He brings the pressure from the field.
Yeah. Yeah.
You're right.
I want to see this thing. Great job.
Using his body. Watch his length. He keeps his length.
Left arm.
He's like this.
There's my late separation. One hand. Boom, boom.
McShay, do you mind if we just take 16 and 8 with us to the Monday Night Football script?
Oh, man.
Just take them. Because I'm pretty sure it could happen.
How about Sunshine.
The, how about 324 the of Ross?
Oh, Ross. That's what I'm saying, though. We saw him on the
Justin
release.
Ross.
On the release, on the touchdown. Now he comes back. Yeah. Most receivers on those go balls, they just drift. He kept it there. He kept the defender with that left arm. He didn't push off.
Yeah, so
he just kept in there
and then
got it.
A little bit of separation. I like how Clemson's not. They're not backing off.
No.
Oh,
he's down.
Just as I say it.
No, he's down. That's down.
Let's go look.
Yeah, let's take a look at it. He's down, man. I'm pretty sure he's down.
Let's watch it. Watch him.
Yeah, he's down. He's down.
Slow it.
Right there.
Slow it.
Right there. He's down. Watch it on the field. Ball. Down.
Yeah, he's
Ball's
down.
Ball to the hand. Ball can't, the ground can't cause a fumble. He's down.
That's a better look.
And here's the rule of thumb on that. Like, if you ever watch it and the ball just goes, bounces, goes straight up in the air, the ground usually calls that.
Right.
Like, if it goes straight up.
Crazy as it seems, they can hold on to a field goal, still only on three possession game.
At 40,
it'd be 24. Yeah. Three possession, three eights.
Knees down there.
Three eights. But I'm just
three
saying.
Eights with a bunch of defensive backs that can't stop number 8 and number 16 from getting the job
done.
True freshman.
Yes.
True freshman playing like this.
I like the positive thinking, though. What?
No, I'm just trying to give us a ball game for ratings.
It's all about ratings.
You said ratings. Ratings. What time do you think we're thinking?
I'll answer you quickly.
Tess told me I'm a broadcaster now.
He is.
You flipped him quickly.
He flipped him. I mean, seriously.
Wow.
82. From Pro Bowl to TV executive.
Are we peaking right now, or do you think we peaked earlier?
I think when the boat was in the water.
The boat was in the water.
When we first put the boat in the water.
You said we were peaking in?
Oh, man.
You know, another thing, though, about Clemson, and I kind of felt this on the field today, and I wasn't sure of this, is, you know, when you go against Nick Saban teams, it's almost like Tiger Woods back when he was rolling.
Right.
When you got on Sunday, yep. If you were with Tiger, you felt like, I got to be perfect.
Yeah.
Like, he's just too good.
Yeah.
If I'm not perfect, he's going to beat me because he's Tiger Woods. It's what it's like playing Nick Saban.
Here's that ruling on that fumble, non-fumble.
After review, the runner was down before he lost.
Yeah, as Boog said.
But my point is, there's an intimidation fact of Alabama, the tradition, Nick Saban, greatest coach ever, his team, his players, been the number one recruits. And Clemson, I think, when Deshaun Watson, he was able to beat them, they played in this game before.
Yep.
There was something like, we're not intimidated by them out there today.
Yep.
Like, I felt it in warm-ups. Like, we're not scared of these guys. We're good. We respect them. We have a healthy respect for them.
Mm-hmm.
But they're not intimidated, and it's showing up.
I think that should be clipped right there. Brian Ryder, can you clip that right there? Can we get that out on social media right there? That's the summation of what... Yeah.
Yeah. That's it.
Well, that's, you know... That's what we talked about early on, of what we experienced down on the field and the way Dabo was.
And they come back, picked it up. You saw it.
Look at it.
Oh! Throw. Wow. They are putting on a clinic right now.
Okay. Stop.
Wow.
Just stop
wow.
right now with him. Stop with Ross.
Wow. Look at it. He's smiling.
Please just stop.
He's smiling. Look
Whit.
At it.
Whit, please stop. True freshman. Whit. Book.
Oh, wow.
What are we doing?
My.
What are we doing?
Wow. All right,
but
Jay,
what are we doing? The best part about
if freshman
what
could come out, where would he go?
Where are we going?
Hey, watch this, though.
Hey, watch this, though, okay?
Oh, you want to see?
Hold on.
Yeah.
I got to get this guy's mock draft called up.
Look at this, though. He has outside leverage, okay? And so he has an out route. It's hard to get outside on an out route when you're already on the inside of the numbers.
So you got to. He's going to stem inside to get him to turn.
Yeah, he leverages.
Then get back vertical, buy yourself space, and then come out on that out route. And then and to make that catch. I mean,
hey, you don't
talk about, you talk about Odell going back like this one hand. You talk about all these catches. The hardest one is when you go back like this. Right. You can kind of, you know, your hand can go with it, so you can take the force, and it's a little bit easier to catch that ball. So if you throw it right here.
Whoa!
Give me that ball. That was
give me that ball.
Hey, Ryder, clip that one too.
Yeah. Hey, that was a little firm throw.
I mean, you want a little touch. Yeah, put some touch on the ball.
Little touch. You always
come on, Carlito. Put some touch on it.
Little touch. Yeah. So that's easy. But here's the thing. Yeah. Now if it's out there, that's a much tougher.
Okay.
That type of catch.
Okay.
Like, did you catch that, by the way?
Yeah. Hey, so I like you, baby. I like you.
Still got a little bit left.
Hey, Jason Garrett, if you're watching, you didn't see that. You didn't see that, okay? But to go back across your body, that's a hard catch that he just made.
Yeah. And then also watch this, too. Watch 16. When's the ball come out?
Before he even out of cut, isn't it?
Right? Was a catch. There. Before he's even out of the cut, and he's that's taking a big hit there.
Yeah.
I mean, he hangs in there, gets the ball out just on time, puts it in a perfect spot, and that's big time.
That's anticipation.
Does the position, that's what you want to look for in a quarterback.
Yeah, McShay does too, buddy.
Oh, where is it? Is it your
point? He said McShay does.
I thought you just what the hell are we doing here?
Do you do the position by position, or is it Baltimore?
It's Baltimore.
Kuiper McShay's primer, is it under the primer? Where is it? Big board, top 32? Where is it?
You're not going to find him on here. You have to be out of school for 3 years.
I know that. I want to know the. I want to see the ones that going
that route.
I want to see the wide receivers going in.
But to get back vertical,
is it the primer?
Yeah,
it's gotta
be
the
primer. I saw that, yeah.
This is so hard
to find.
Watch
him stem in.
Oh, watch Etienne. Oh, turn the corner. Jeez.
Oh, where is the position by position? The primer is a nice article, though. You write that or they write that for you?
Yeah, we wrote that. Over the phone.
Stop.
There's like 10 editors back in Bristol.
Dictated it.
That's nice, though. I may read that on the plane.
I used to type
draft. What is this? Where can I just find
when Dabo went to bring your own guts, everything changed. Everything changed for this whole program.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like.
Yeah, Marquise Brown is the only receiver.
Is that Hollywood?
Yeah.
Okay, so
where? First round. He would be the first, it looks like. I mean, we're talking two games, but.
Just make a statement. I want to know.
I'm
desperate for the information.
Yes, I think he looks like he would be the first
quarterback. So the true freshman quarterback
and
the true freshman receiver, if they were in this draft,
and
would be
they can't go anywhere for 2 years.
I understand that.
It's crazy.
But if they were in this draft, they'd be the top receiver you'd have and the top quarterback you'd have.
So when I got my boards, okay, we called the game on Saturday. When I got my boards, I was looking at them. The first thing that I saw about Ross when after I seen him on tape, Todd,
is he's from Alabama?
Was from Alabama.
Right.
How in the world did he get out of Alabama?
Good question. That's a really good question.
Saban tried to recruit him.
Obviously. I'm sure he did.
He said he tried.
Dabo, going into Alabama.
Well, Dabo's an Alabama guy.
Yeah, I know, but
Pelham, Alabama.
6'4", 210.
Pretty good.
What is he, 18?
Six receptions 19? For 153 yards.
At the most, 19.
Got 153 yards and a touchdown on 9 targets, plus the 74-yarder that ripped the game wide open.
How many times have we said
I'm dying here for you.
In Nick Saban's career? At the end of the third quarter, the fat lady could be singing. Yeah. I mean, she is warming up the vocal cords right now, guys.
Oh, you're not saying that. I'm going to take you back to the 2007 season. Look at this.
Oh, wow.
Now, this is the other one. Look, this is the other one here.
Hey.
This T. Higgins, the other 6'4 receiver. What a throw.
The go-to guy. There's a flag, too, at the end.
Boom. One,
great job
two.
Working underneath.
Yeah.
You see, sometimes you got to adjust your route as a receiver.
It. Right here.
You see him work underneath and then get back out. Flattens it out.
I'm going to take you back to that season.
Take it back to either Sky Cam or high end zone, McShay, when you get a chance.
Got it.
All right, take a look at 73. 73 is going to get beat inside. All right, he's going to get beat inside, but just watch the pause. You don't see this from a freshman. Once the right tackle gets beat, he's staring down the barrel right there.
That's pretty good.
I mean, look at him.
Look at this.
Freezing right there.
He knows it's coming.
He is staring down the barrel and he steps into the throw.
And look, there's a defender right there.
Yeah. Dude!
Throws it right over his.
It's been a big time showing.
Wow.
Right over him.
Right over top of him.
Hey, boys, I'm going to call it right now. Good night. Good night. Good night. How many times at the end of three quarters have you ever said good night to a Nick Saban team?
Yeah.
It's over.
Yeah, it's over.
It's over.
53 yards, and it's 400.
Of all the predictions,
that's right. That's right.
53 yards.
I got you.
400.
I got you.
Clemson working Alabama. Plus one option.
I got you.
You're right. Yeah. Trevor Lawrence is his name.
Yeah. Trevor Lawrence.
It just it wasn't an option. There was no way that Clemson was going to run them out of the gym like this.
No, no.
You know, that, that was an incredible throw, but watch this, though, the other part of it.
The Dabo's ability to, in the scheme of this offense to be able to, like, play it through, give him reads.
Yeah.
And going against Nick's secondary, you usually don't see it. You're right, Todd, this doesn't really go fast, does it?
I'm doing my best.
So when you have that pass, really they got three over two here, right? So you got these three
on both.
So
sides.
He's going to hook up and then pull him out. Now he should immediately just double. You play inside, you play outside, and he's going to run in and come underneath, like you said, and then get back over top. And he should have right here. Very rarely do you see Nick's secondary play like that.
Right.
But the speed, it shows you the athleticism of him to come under and then, of course, the throw right over top of that. So, in theory, it's 4-2 with him dropping out underneath. What a throw.
Oof.
And catch.
Wow.
That last drive was a display.
12 touchdowns on the year for T. Higgins.
Wow.
And you can see Nick's frustration because he had inside help there. The safety, you got the dick. A lot of push-up.
What is wrong with this?
So that 2007 season, when Saban first got there when he replaced Shula,
yep.
That was the year they lost to Louisiana Monroe.
Yeah, yeah.
That was the year that Saban had his largest deficit in a game up until this point right now.
Jeez.
This is the largest deficit for Alabama under Nick Saban.
Trevor Lawrence on third down, guys, is 8-11 for 240 on third
That's
down.
Absurd. That's
on
absurd.
On third down. Are you kidding me?
That's ridiculous.
Now, if you're Dabo, you got to, you know, tell some of the freshmen that hadn't played, hey, y'all want to get in and get some of this?
What would be the odds that we were going to say that?
You imagine?
Meanwhile,
man,
two is
oh, man.
3-10.
Yeah.
Third down.
Yeah.
It's beyond it.
Yeah.
Beyond Deshaun Watson's prediction.
He said
Deshaun Watson said the receivers will tear up their DBs.
And that's
win
exactly
by
what they've done. Justin Ross, who all season long really was their number three or four receiver, if you're counting Renfro as a three. The last two games, when it counts in the playoff, 12 catches, 301 yards, and 3 touchdowns.
Wow.
Yeah.
Crazy.
He has superior athleticism to people. I mean, he just does. Two have been aired out.
So if you're taking a quarterback starting your franchise.
That's not even close.
Here's the interesting part, he's got the physical stature. A week ago, it was a quarterback, Kyler Murray, Tua, and Tua outplayed him.
Oh, no question. Yeah, but that's not, I would agree with that.
And then this week, in 1 week difference.
It makes your job very easy.
Yeah.
They're giving you all the answers to the test right in front of you.
No, I understand. I'm just saying I'm surprised at how different 1 week can be for Tua.
You had the Senior Bowl now, Michelle?
Yes.
When you had done?
It's the 22nd. Yeah.
So you're going to start getting into film pretty hard right now?
Yeah. We're going to spend one day with the kids tomorrow.
Yeah,
haven't seen them in a while.
They deserve that.
You get one day.
They deserve that, yeah.
And then we're on it.
Yeah. That guy deserved it. Brent Venables, what a night for him, huh? Yeah.
How is he not up for some head jobs?
He must not interview
well,
with us.
He's making $2 million.
Yeah, he's
helps.
Right there. He's one of the
he's made some life decisions that he really prefers.
His kids,
there's contentment.
Yeah,
he loves the culture of the place.
And his kids are there.
Yeah, and he loves the staff. He loves the culture. There's definitely a fit with Dabo. We're coming to the end of the third quarter here.
I do wonder.
That was nice and stride. Nice and stride. Jerry Judy, zeros on the clock. Judy's pretty special, too. I know we're raving about the other kid because he's been spectacular, but Judy's pretty special, too.
He is.
44-16 at the end of three. We're going to take a short break right here. The MegaCast continues Monday Night Football Film Room plus Todd McShay right here. What's up, everybody? We're cleaning up pizza here on the MegaCast. You are watching the Monday Night Football Film Room. Joe Tessitore, Booger McFarland, Jason Witten with ball in hand, and Todd McShay. What are you, writing another article for .com?
No, do you get paid by the article? How does that work?
Move over, Adam Schefter.
I'm preparing for Van Pelt. We got to hit after and try to get some
plays. That'll be good. 44-16 as we start the fourth quarter here. It has been domination by Clemson as Trevor Lawrence. I mean, you talk about like a star is born and how obvious it is. The true freshman quarterback, Ross, the true freshman wide receiver. Ross is sitting at 153 yards and a touchdown, had the 74-yarder. And Trevor Lawrence is at 347 and three touchdowns. What did you say to Booger before the night started?
I said, you're going to watch this guy throw for 400 yards, and you're not going to call him Sunshine anymore. You're going to call him Trevor Lawrence. And that's what he's done.
Yeah.
Listen, I don't want to overhype this. Maybe I was thinking about it in the break.
I don't think there is
for 19 years old.
Yeah.
Greatest in history? Maybe Vince Young?
Of a championship performance?
Oh.
Obviously, the pressure. I mean, Young played an epic all-time game. But you know what? I mean, I'd go back to this book. The way the night started with him, where he was overjuiced, he was like, it reminded me of like when I call a championship fight.
Yeah. And then he threw one almost into the first row.
Yeah. And, you know, when they're just trying to get him a completion on a wide receiver screen, and then to just be like sublime, like just nearly flawless since then with everything.
Speaks volume for the kid, man.
It really does.
Well, that's what, when you go into Clemson and talk to Dabo and talk to the staff, they said the first thing that they noticed was he's not a hugely vocal leader, but when he came in, he was mature, confident in what he was going to do, kind of had a plan, and everyone around him gravitates to him, even though he's not a rah-rah guy. He's humble, but he's really confident.
That's a good ball right there. Yeah.
And that he was just different from any other freshman that they've ever dealt with.
You know, even in warm-ups, like, I mean, he was just taking
when we were sitting out there at the 50-yard line in warm-ups, where's everybody's eyes? Where were all the eyes?
Oh, yeah.
Coming out of his hand.
Yeah.
Like, how was he spinning it?
Yeah.
Everybody's face. What direction was everybody facing in warm-up?
Facing
all
him.
Of us, right?
Yeah.
The four of us, Herb Street, we were all watching him. What do you got here, Whip? What do you got here, Boog?
Clemson's bringing pressure. Here they come.
They got a man beater with this two sacks.
Yeah, it's man. Here they come.
They're bringing pressure. Throwing the wheel up to the back.
There you go.
You're going to turn the corner. Yeah. Oh, he couldn't reach it. Harris.
They tried to isolate that back all the entire game, you know?
Yeah.
I want to tuck it away.
Nuh-uh.
He tried. Yeah.
He got it the one. Just outside the one.
I mean, I get it. We're not going to come back and win this game, but why are we huddled?
Yeah.
Just like, the clock's moving.
Concession. Man, you ever think you'd say that?
No.
The word I just said?
Concession.
He's got a fight to get in. Didn't get in. He's pushing back. Didn't get in.
Red zone's been a nightmare for them.
It really has. What do we got in red zone? What's red zone right now?
They're 1-for-3, but then they also had
this field goal.
The field goal.
Oh, don't even.
Yeah.
That wasn't in the red zone, I don't think. The fake field goal was outside the red zone, right? Because they were at 24-yard line.
Yeah,
it was a 40-something yard attempt.
Right.
That was one of the worst calls. That call was horrific.
But think about this. Here's what that not getting in, it cost you 45 seconds.
Correct.
Right.
Yeah. Well,
they're going to run it again. Run.
Yeah. Same. Same. Got undercut.
Same play.
Christian Wilkins. Southfield Academy.
On the backside, too.
Yeah, that sack football right there.
Oh, look at the inside. Look at him get across Leatherwood's face. Wow.
Yeah.
The best part, too, is he plays down the line, Buck.
Like, totally. He just keeps playing.
Oh, you see what he did to Leatherwood there?
Yeah.
That kid was a 5-star.
They're running it again.
Here he is.
Yeah, look at him go inside Leatherwood, just go down. Wow.
Where you got him? Where you got Wilkins in the draft next year?
First round. Middle first.
Yep.
Yeah.
He's the least talented in terms of just raw talent
of the
three.
Yeah.
Furrow and Lawrence.
Right out.
But
right
he plays.
Now. Right now, quick flat to four.
Plays his tail off.
They penetrated here.
What a play by Farrell.
There's Farrell.
Was that fourth down? Wow.
Just unbelievable.
This is
they went with the quarterback sweep.
What would you say? When they got down to the 1 yard line, they said, oh, the red zone's been horrible for them. So this is how they're going to close out this game with that? Not even come away with points with that?
But this is a great play by Farrell.
But hold on. Here's the thing, though. You're going to run a sweep, and guess how many guys are out here?
And into the boundary.
Yeah. Freeze it. In the boundary. There's three guys outside.
Freeze it right there. Now, between – you got one, two, three.
Yeah, look.
You got five guys from the left guard this way to the bottom of the screen. Yes, five guys.
And you're on the boundary.
Exactly.
Yep. And this had no chance.
Watch Farrell, though. Long arms. Look at that.
They didn't even block him.
Look how long those arms are.
It literally did not block him.
Hey, we're supposed to say his name Furl.
Furl,
now,
yeah.
Like, he wants his name pronounced Furl, like Ruffurl.
Correct.
Furl.
Furl.
Furl. Almost like F-U-R-L.
Right.
Furl.
All I know is if you're running a toss sweep or even a QB sweep,
the
play side defensive end has to get touched. He literally does not get touched.
Give me that whip. Show me.
Watch him. Watch Furl. He's right here, but they don't turn and block him. He's going on the edge. They're all going to the perimeter.
Yeah, 82's going up.
Three guys are going on the perimeter, and they don't block him.
So 66 has got to reach to him?
Yeah, he's got to. Or 73's just got to get the play started.
He's got to get the play started.
You're not going to get outside of him there.
Oh, yeah, 73's got to first get just get
and
him.
You've got 34. You got Harris.
Well, hold up. Go back.
Yep. You got back. Harris and normally, Smith working to the perimeter, too.
Normally, somebody will crack the end. They're cracking the strong safety there.
Yep.
Take a look at that.
Normally, you crack the end right there.
Yeah.
He's going to get the safety. That's the reason nobody touched it.
Should he have cracked the end?
Normally, all the tosses.
Then it's not an issue. Yeah.
And he doesn't have to really crack him. He just gets
away. Just getting away.
Exactly.
And then he's not doing this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, if they could have got the edge set, they had a chance.
Right.
Venables has had a night now.
Wow.
I know Trevor Lawrence, the two freshmen are sensational on offense, but Venables scheme-wise, he's out coaching Oxley.
To hold Tua in this offense, record-setting offense to 16 points. And they've given up
150 yards rushing, almost 400 yards offense.
447 yards of total offense, and they just can't finish. And it's very unlike...
1-for-4 in the red zone.
It's been mistakes.
Yeah.
The pick six, the fake field goal, the goal line stand. I mean, just...
That's very undamaged.
Not finishing drives.
Self-inflicted wounds and not finishing in the red zone.
Yep.
And a couple sloppy moments.
But Dabo, all the hype of playing Alabama. One penalty for 12 yards.
Yes.
Zero turnovers. I mean, you want to capitalize in that game? I mean, that's what you have to do.
You know, well,
get two turnovers on the other side.
It's one of the things that people that play Alabama have talked about for years. There are only a few coaches that don't get enamored by the mystique. Dabo, Urban Meyer.
Yep.
Okay, they don't get enamored. When their teams show up, it's not the almighty Alabama. It's, hey, we're good, they're good, let's go play.
Yeah, it's Buster Douglas against Tyson.
Right,
and Nick knew that about Dabo.
Right, exactly.
Nick knew that about Dabo. I mean, he had all the respect in the world for Clemson. He knew what they were capable of doing.
You said a few, but you could only name two, and I think you were right.
Right. That's why I stopped.
Yeah.
Well, who else is there? You know, the only other guy that gave him fits a little bit in recent years wasn't because of necessarily the attitude of playing them. It was the Ole Miss stuff sort of getting ahead of what they recruited to.
Right.
And Kirby.
Right.
Kirby played him tough.
Kirby had beaten him.
Yeah, I know he hasn't beat him, but I mean, I'm just saying.
He's played him tough, but he hasn't beat him.
Yeah.
And to that point, Kirby's gotten out coached at the end of the game twice.
Right.
The fake punt.
Oh, the fake punt. Yep.
The fake punt this past year.
This fake field goal was worse than that fake punt.
Oh, question.
I think they're the same. I mean, Kirby.
Situationally,
Kirby ran a fake punt with Justin Fields.
You didn't need to do it.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, but just keep your offense on the field or run speed option.
That was the point where the game was over. After that.
They're still throwing it. Oh, look at him. He baited it.
I love that play.
Go ahead and tell me why.
So look at this play. This is awesome. So it's same coverage. He's going to bait this corner. He's going to run a quick out, and he's going to make him throw it. You know, just like the interception we saw Clemson hit.
Yep.
And then he's going to run this little outside, find that turkey hole little area there where they're trying to hit it. See, baits him. This corner comes off, and now he's going to throw it here. He just misses on the throw.
I love the fact that they're still throwing.
Oh, yeah. But that was the right idea.
Yeah.
That's where you want to go. There's that area right in behind there. If the corner's going to come off, let's go where he was supposed to be.
Yeah, now you just
–
I think you hand it off and run it here.
Was there any bet attached to the 400 yards passing?
Back shoulder.
Oh, call that. Put that away. He's mad at himself. Look at Steve Levy. He could have made the play. Hey, Levy could have made the play right there. Back that up. You got program? Do you have program? You got program on there?
Yeah, bud.
That doesn't. Is that? Watch this. Watch Levy. I think Levy could have made this play.
They love that back shoulder, though.
No, the one on the near side. Near side.
Come on.
You know who Ross reminds me of?
Who?
Is AJ Green.
Oh, I knew how you were going to go there.
Yeah, I mean, he's just, yeah, he's just, got the, we've got been partners body. This year. And he's good at the line of scrimmage. Like, when you're long, a lot of guys that are long, no, everything's on the stride. Before. Right?
There he is.
Oh, yeah. Oh, right, what's the Levy? Hey, how does Levy take this?
Levy.
How does Levy take this?
Levy's used to be.
Oh, break this down for me.
Hey,
I work at sideline with Levy and Greasy. He never goes down the field. He's not used to being down there. He's a sports center guy.
Yeah, right.
He has no idea what's going on here. Watch this.
I think his head is turned away from the play. I think he's got his head away from the play.
Look at it. He kind of held his ground, though.
Look at that smile.
Look at that grin. Look at his smile. Oh. Look at Levy. Oh, man, he's grinning. He's got the pocket square.
The reason
square
he's
going.
Smiling is he's like, I know they got me. I know it.
Look at that.
Huh? Look at that. Are we taking a break or not, Ryder?
That's great.
Take a break. Oh, wait. Go back. Hey, but did you see his balance in absorbing the blow?
He hung in there.
He hung in there. You got to give him some credit there.
I think it
wouldn't have happened if his head was to the play. You got to coach him up on that.
That's a good thing.
You got to coach him up on that a little bit.
That was a highlight of the second half.
Oh, it was unbelievable. Exactly. Unbelievable.
He's got some strength to him. He's got some strength to him. Don't sleep on Levy.
Hockey guy.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah. If Clemson scores another point, it's the most points ever scored against Saban at Alabama.
Wow.
How about that?
Boom. When you get back to the hotel.
That is a correct statement, right, G?
Talk to me about what you're ordering.
A lot.
First of all, I'm not going back to the hotel.
Okay. When you get to wherever you go,
there's an In-N-Out burger on the way.
Okay. There you go.
Give me the double-double.
Double-double animal style. Double-double.
He's going to have that thing
animal
down.
Style.
And then he's going to do this. Here's the best part about Boog. You ready? Here's the best part. I'll take a Diet Dr. Pepper.
I'm not taking those calories.
Give me
the full order.
I'll take a double-double animal style. Okay.
What's animal styles with the...
extra like sauce, dog.
Extra ketchup, okay? I'll take a large fry, all right? Ketchup for the fries, okay? And then it's either Diet Dr. Pepper Hogo, unsweet tea. I got my own.
Where's the sugar at?
Unsweet his own tea.
Because he's got the stevia. It's right there.
So you can go double-double, and then go with the Diet Dr. Pepper.
You may be right. We don't really use a lot of this, you know, New Haven, Connecticut, where we're taking down Pepper's pieces. We're not really.
Yeah.
Hey. That thing's going to be down before he even gets out of the drive-thru.
Oh, I have no idea. Oh. Jeez, come on.
That is good stuff. You know, these kids aren't going to know what to do in the locker room.
Which ones? Alabama or Clemson?
Oh, Clemson ain't going to know what to do. Christian Wilkins is going to be doing splits and dancing so much, you're going to think this is Danny Terrio in 1979.
Tell you what, that's a long flight back.
I love
Tuscaloosa.
That's right.
With the toothpick in your mouth.
That's right. That's a wisp now.
No, I know.
This is like
Go get it.
Yeah. Well, you got one, you know.
That was incredible.
What do you do with that, by the way? I'm just curious.
Well, you eat a lot of cashews. You got to get out of
here. Carlito.
What do we got here?
They're taking him out.
Oh, man.
Now, you know what?
Should this have happened earlier?
Is he hurt? Let's check out.
You think the Twitter machine is going to know if he's hurt?
Well, somebody might know.
You think the Twitter machine is like on the
side? I like it, though. I like it. I mean,
yeah, why not? Yeah. I mean, 44-16, this kid, we talked about it on Monday Night Football last week, right? Give this kid credit, man.
Yeah.
Coming off the SEC championship, sticking with it, staying in there with it, not transferring.
Right.
Day and age of transfer. You got guys before even hit the field already thinking about where can I get playing time and transferring, right? Clemson knows that. Yep. Happened with their quarterback room.
Yep.
Silly. I can't stand that McShay.
We're transferring?
Oh, don't McShay, please.
I disagree.
I know. It's the only position, the only place you can get on the field.
Forget even the position, man. Coaches can walk out on you any day.
There was something else I greatly disagreed with you on this year, and I didn't tell you because
you're not even going to let me explain.
No, because it sparked me. Go ahead.
If you give it any kind of shot,
yeah,
and you just know there's no chance,
and you get an opportunity to go play somewhere else. I mean, why is it that the players don't get paid? The players are jerks if they don't finish the season playing a bowl game. The players are a problem when, you know, at some point, deserve some rights.
But when a freshman does it before he even hits the field, he's been redshirted, you don't want to compete?
I said you have to give it a shot.
Yeah, you got to give it a shot. You got to compete
for a while. But if you get to the point where, as a grad transfer, I'm saying.
That's right.
When you graduated school,
no, of course,
you've seen it out for three and a half years,
but
4 years.
Let's take Justin Fields. Okay, Justin Fields, five-star. He made the decision to come to Georgia knowing that Jake Fromm was there.
He competed for the job.
Competed for the job. He lost. Are you okay with him leaving?
Well, after 2 years.
It was 2 years.
2 years.
Was 2 years or 1 year?
I'm okay with it.
No, 1 year. Yeah,
it's 1 year. Are you okay with him leaving? Because I am.
Listen, I'm all about the student athlete.
I
don't like the I guess chasing point. Just give it a shot. See what happens. You never know what's going to happen.
And do what? Set for 3 years?
No, not for 3 years. But if you gave it a good shot. And
just admit I won this argument.
You won the argument. Well, you know what I didn't like? I didn't like your Ed Oliver argument.
Oh, really?
I was watching that Thursday night game with the whole coach.
I will debate you for days on this.
Well, we only got 10 minutes and 9 seconds. So. It's a bad look.
Yeah, it was a bad look, that was the coach mounted frustration over him. Yeah. He probably shut it down. Once they lost a couple of games, he was injured but didn't want to come back, and he was worried about losing money in the draft.
No, right. I understand that.
Yeah, and then about a jacket. After everything that kid has done for that program.
I get you. Yeah, but we don't need to have a fight. We don't need to have almost a physical altercation between a head coach.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
Where do you stand on the guys not playing in the bowl game before they're going to go?
I want them to compete. I get it. It's terrible for college football, but if I'm playing in it's tough because God like the you. Fiesta Bowl, Orange Thank Bowl, you. those are tradition storied bowls. I'd like to see him play, but
so
I also
the Fiesta where Jalen Smith got hurt.
I have been on the field when Jalen Smith got hurt after sitting with him in a meeting room, and it was heartbreaking. And I was on the field with Jake Butt the next year.
Yeah.
2 years in a row, I've watched those guys. And Jake Butt's still not the same.
Yeah.
And Jalen Smith, thankfully, finally, 3 years
later. Here's my thing, and I get that part of it. And I'm actually, if you compete for a job, I'm 100% okay you transferring. I think it's great that you go transfer. He'll be the starting quarterback. Fields will be the starting quarterback of Ohio State.
Right. Yeah.
Right? So, all good, man. And he'll probably have a great career over here and go into the NFL.
Sparkling water.
Sparkling water, excuse me. Can I get an unnamed sparkling water that comes in a green bottle and is imported from Italy?
I'll take the water also.
Ella Greeno
or Diet Coke if you have one.
I don't know if you know Ella. Miss Greeno.
I disagree.
This is like a disaster over here.
The man's in the middle of the point.
Tess is over here talking about the water. We're trying to talk football. Do you love it? Come on, baby.
I love it. I love it. And you know how much I love this too.
Please.
No, don't worry about it.
It'll take a double-double with that unsweet tea, please.
At least we lasted the fourth quarter before we came off the rails.
Fourth quarter, we got 10 minutes and two seconds.
But think about this. If I'm a general manager,
we
saw John Lynch down on the field today.
Yeah.
Right? And I see a player, a star player that's going to be a top pick, and he's not dressed out, and he's in they even come to the game. If I'm the coach, I'm going to put him on the sideline.
Yeah, why?
And you say, hey, it's my career more than – because, look, and Jalen Smith, incredible story how he came back. But, Willie McGinnis did it. Frank Gore did it coming off those injuries. And Butwell, too. He'll come back and play. I just think it says a lot about your mindset. You're going to make money doing that.
You're not the only one who thinks that.
But I just think as a teammate, as a captain and player, can I trust that guy? Can I depend on him in the middle of the fourth quarter? Because he can get hurt the next year and never get the second contract. I get all that.
Greedy Williams has a daughter and doesn't have very much money. And
God bless him.
And he's the cornerback for LSU.
Yeah.
And he's a star. He's going to be the top 10, top 15 pick.
Yep.
And he didn't play in the bowl game. Now, Devin White, the linebacker.
Oh, he was everywhere, man.
Could have done the same thing. And probably
we love some Devin White right here.
Oh, he is. And he's just as good a dude and a guy to sit down and talk to. He loves the game.
That ever leave your mind, though? Like, as a competitive player, does that affect you? If you're the head coach or you're in charge of running the team, does that affect you with drafting that guy? Does it just say something about him? Maybe it doesn't affect you whether you draft him or not.
If I know Greedy Williams went in and was crying to Devin, telling him that, you know, I'm not going to play because I got a daughter and I got to take care of her.
Yeah,
So there are circumstances, you know?
Yeah, I'm with you.
Yeah. Now, Will Greer, quarterback, that's I don't want to dive deeper on that. Like why a quarterback to me is
can't happen.
Go play,
mind.
Right?
I think he's a heck of a football player.
Me too.
But I'm depending on that guy to come in the huddle and tell 10 other teammates, trust me, listen to me, look at me in the eyes. I'm gonna be the guy that's gonna lead us. Our hopes and dreams at this ball that can provide. Because I got kids too that are living their dream through me playing that game.
Right.
That you're gonna walk into that huddle, and I'm gonna lean on you and depend on you to take me to where we want to go. You're the leader of this offense, and I know you didn't play in that game.
I think here's the difference
at that position. It just says a lot about it.
That was different to me.
I think that's fair, McShay.
I totally agree.
Yeah.
To me, here's the
quarterback
difference.
That's concerning.
To me, here's the difference. We look at football almost like life and death sometimes, and I think we forget what we're doing when we play. It's a team sport, but number one, it's entertainment for fans. Number two, it's a job for us. So it's employment. All right? And so what you're asking kids to do is to get through with the interview process. And they've been called and said, hey, you got the job. Just show up to work on Monday. All right? And they're ensuring that they'll show up on Monday with no accidents by not playing. And so now you got the job. Like, all these guys have put the work in. I understand what you're saying. But you put the work in. You won the job.
But you know what, though, Book? Here's where I would – and I hear you. But I think this is where I differ is this. I never viewed it as a job when I went out there. Like, there's a business moment. Like, when I'm negotiating a contract with your agent and all that kind of stuff. But when I never stepped on the football field and thought, this is my job. This is how I put food on the table for my kids. Look, I'm playing because I love football.
Right.
Whether it was across the street in that parking lot or whether it's in front of 85,000 people. I'm playing because I love.
Right.
Right? And I may get hurt. And I may not, you know, catch 15 balls. Or there's a lot of things that may not happen. But when you start, when that enters your mind, as a teammate, I don't know about it as a general manager, as a head coach, but as a teammate, I have a really hard time thinking, especially at certain positions that I'm dependent on, I have a hard time to say, ah, man, I'm going to let that one slide because you're trying to get paid. We're all trying to get paid. That's line one. But you can't think about that when you line up, especially on Sundays.
You don't think about that when you're on the field playing because you're playing and you put your body through all the training and the grind to get ready to play on the field. You don't think about it. But when you're off the field and you're trying to make this decision, do I play, do I not play? Especially at 19.
Yeah.
At 19 or 20, the money comes into play. Because some of these kids, Greedy Williams, didn't have any money. I grew up, I was a middle child.
Let me ask you this. How did it work out for Frank Gore? Major injury. How did it work for Jalen Smith? How did it work for Willis McGahee.
Right.
How did it work out for those guys? I mean,
are you willing to take that chance, though? Do you have to take
that chance? Well, here's the thing with Jalen, though. He had, I think, $700,000 off of insurance. He had a big play.
Look at this. Pull that back. Make sure you hit that.
But he lost about $15 million, maybe $20 million in his first contract. So you got to get to
the second. But I tell you what, playing with Jalen, there wasn't anybody that inside that locker room didn't have more respect for him.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't appreciate it. And you know what? I bet if he was sitting right here, he said, I would not have changed it either. Because he's grown from that. He's got perspective on that. Yeah, did he lose some money? Yeah, he did. But, you know, it's just, to me, there's, and it's easy to say it when you play 15 years and things go well and you make money.
Right.
So I understand that.
I get it.
But I just think he'll be a better player eventually. Now, I understand he has a major injury, but he's a better person. He's a better player. He wouldn't change that experience. And Greer and some of these guys, it messes with me. I can't. I think it's just
I can't
dip your toe in the water like that.
Right. I know this game's over, but it's still more of it. Like they don't know.
Break it down.
They don't know where they're lining up.
Oh yeah.
The defensive end.
Alabama. Look at. Yeah. That's not Alabama. 30 and
32. That's not Alabama. And then the
watch the loaf.
Defensive end. He's not able to get contained.
Look at Dabo.
And there's nobody there over the top.
You guys see the live footage of Dabo?
Yeah.
Number 88.
Hey, you got can you rerun program where they get that bump back from break of Dabo playing for Gene Stallings?
This is program. Okay.
Yeah, keep going.
That's a great clip.
Yeah.
They're still
playing. Oh, he gets some. Here's your yards. Here's your yards. Oh, he didn't even get back to the line screen. Yeah, here's what he's just talking about. Our guys are going to run it for you. Most wins by head coach in Clemson history. Everybody went to Alabama.
Wow. That's pretty cool.
How about that?
All the great coaches in Clemson history played at Alabama.
Danny Ford.
tell you a story about Danny Ford really quick since we're in story time.
Doesn't have to be quick either.
So Danny Ford, hey, Danny Ford is the head coach at Arkansas.
Yep.
I'm a high school senior being recruited. I had three choices at the end. Phil Former, Tennessee, Arkansas, LSU. I'll tell you how I went to LSU. It's a great story. I take a recruiting trip to go up to Tennessee. Phil Former's the head coach.
They're still running Lawrence.
Yeah, without a doubt. I don't know what Dabo's thinking. Okay, but Peyton Manning's a quarterback.
He wants 50.
I go to the game. After the game, Phil brings me down the field, Rocky Top, Neyland Stadium. Phil puts his arm around me and says, Anthony, look around. And I'm looking around. He says, don't you feel it? He says, I want you to imagine something. So I want you to get down in the stance. I want you to bend over. Now imagine Peyton Manning sliding his hands under your rear end.
He wanted you to play center.
He wanted me to play center. He said, can you feel it? I said, no, Phil, I can't feel that. I couldn't feel that. So that's why I didn't
play in center.
So I didn't want to play center. That's why I didn't go to Tennessee. Oh, fast forward about a month. Danny Ford, Arkansas, comes to the house. All right, I grew up in a small house. We had what we called the living room, where you had the plastic still on the furniture.
Oh, no question.
No question. Plastic still on the furniture. The only time you took it off was when somebody came that was important.
Yeah.
Danny Ford comes in the house. Mama cooked a huge meal. Everything laid out, everything that you would love for Danny Ford.
Yeah.
Danny Ford comes in the living room. No plastic on the furniture. His first move on the coffee table was this.
No!
I looked at my mom. I said, I know I'm not going to Arkansas.
Danny thought you were going to like that.
Yeah. She put his boots on my mama's coffee table. Danny Ford. Are you kidding me?
Come on. That's a great story.
Good coach, but bad move. Oh, look at this.
Why is this what are we doing right here? Now? Come on, Dabo.
So I wanted to play my recruiting stories. I wanted to play defense.
Yeah.
And Michigan was one of the only schools that was kind of recruiting me to, you know, come up there. And
you wanted to play defense?
I wanted to play defense initially, really? Yeah. You know, I didn't want to play tight end. And they were like, hey, you can be an athlete, you know, maybe tight end, maybe linebacker, right, and all that stuff. So no cell phone, right? My grandfather's my high school football coach. And he's, like, living his life through me that now they're finally coming to recruit, you know, and he's a big recruit and all that stuff. Small town in Tennessee. And they called my grandmother, all right, at the home, at her home. Home phone, no cells, you know, rings and ding, the whole bit. And she calls. She's like, Coach, Jason's not here right now. And she says, but anyways, it's too cold. It's too cold up there and it's too far away. There's no way he's coming up there. So I get home with my granddad.
Mm-hmm.
And they go to tell me what my grandma said. And I'm devastated. Like, how do you tell Michigan it's too cold and he can't come up there, too far away?
It's too cold.
And my grandfather, he's a great man. He was so disappointed, so frustrated that my grandma told him that Michigan.
It's too cold.
This is 99, 2000. Yeah. Michigan's pretty good.
Oh,
they just won a national championship.
Oh, guy by the name of Brady.
Yeah.
97 Charles Greasy, Woodson, Rose
Bowl. Oh, I love it.
Yeah.
No, it's too cold.
That is something.
She was right.
Yeah, it worked out.
It's cold.
Heck of a career for Christian Wilkins and Hunter Renfrow, huh?
All right. Hey, listen, guys.
We'll see you, man. This is fun.
Boog's going to catch him. I got to go by In-N-Out first.
Talk about quitting on guys.
No, I'm not quitting.
Talk about quitting. That's right.
In the bowl game. That's right.
Listen.
When we go to broadcast the Pro Bowl, I don't know that I can trust all my guys.
Yeah, that's right.
You know what, Tess? I'm going to tell you like this, buddy.
Oh, man.
I'm going to Florida where you can trust me.
Oh,
man.
I wish I was going with you, Boog.
Without a doubt. It's been real, guys.
You need help getting downstairs?
Make sure those golf courses are still working,
Boog. Without a doubt. Hey, it's been real in the film room, baby. It has been real.
It has been. You should see the mess over here. I'm telling you.
It is
like cashews everywhere.
Unfortunately, Boog has a flight to catch.
All right, Boog. You be well.
That's easy, baby. All right,
Boog.
Fall out, Boog.
That was fun, Boog.
That's easy.
Great job down here.
Good TV, Boog.
Do it all the
way. Good TV.
Somewhere Phil Former's. Yeah. No, somewhere Phil Former's cringing right now.
Oh, my.
I don't know whether I'd be mad or jealous.
Oh, man.
Jealous.
This Clemson train is not going to stop.
Oh, no.
With the recruiting, with that staff intact, with how young
they're
are.
They're different, too, man. You know,
well, it's a different kind of culture.
You go to a lot of places and they say, we're family and all that. And sure, places are very much like that. And I do think coaches love their players and so on and so forth. But for some reason, I think the community, what Dabo has established, it really is a different culture.
It is.
It really is.
He is an incredible man. You know, I mean, you think about – it's hard for college football coaches, I think, in this day and age of recruiting and what you're dealing with to have high standards and demand,
yeah,
and then still be liked and enjoyed and respected and all those things. It's either hardcore, right, my way or the highway,
right,
or it's players coach, mm-hmm, right? And it's all the mantras and the fun stuff, and we got the barbershop and all these
there's
different
no
things.
Discipline. He there's finds no a way. To,
and he has both.
Yes.
He's one of the rare guys that has both. He's a ball guy. He's invested. Every day, I think he understands the privilege that he has to be the head coach.
There's a gratefulness.
And think about that. He was on an interim basis
when
he took over.
Completely.
And that was not ideal.
No.
And
as a wide receiver coach.
Absolutely.
As a wide receiver coach.
He was never a coordinator.
Yeah. So give Clemson. Give Clemson.
But in a strange way, it benefited him as a head coach.
No question.
Like delegating, entrusting coordinators, yep, right?
And it wasn't an easy start for him. I mean, it didn't
no,
just like,
no. No. There were those breakthrough moments. So Orange Bowl was a breakthrough moment.
Look at his staff.
Yeah.
They all stay. I mean, look at how many coaches Saban's been through.
Hey, and Christian Wilkins getting really emotional.
And yeah, they're paying him, but they want to be there.
Oh,
there's a reason some of these guys haven't gone on and taken bigger jobs.
No, I mean, they've stayed together when obviously they've been pulled in a lot of different directions. Venables, right?
Yep.
Elliott and Scott, the two offensive guys.
Co-coordinators.
Right? Yeah. Mike Reed, my old buddy from college, DB coach.
You think, though, I mean, what a neat, we're talking about prior to the game, casting out, you know, seeing how poised and relaxed he was on the sideline.
Oh, it was unbelievable.
Think about that, he and his wife grinning ear to ear. Two of their boys are on the team, mm-hmm, walk-ons. I mean, it's a family affair of what they're trying to build and how they've done it. He stayed true to his values and what he believes in, you know? But on the other side of it, I guarantee you tomorrow morning, Nick Saban's out recruiting. He's back at it because nobody is more passionate than him. I mean, he's not going anywhere. You know,
I'm curious as to how the Tide side digests this right here. I really am. Like, this is going to be a much different. Listen, I understand you lose with 1 second left in an all-time classic. All right,
no, this is embarrassing.
This is.
Well, we haven't seen this defense.
No.
Outside of Tua not playing well, right? But he is a really, really good football player. I mean, look at his year he had. Only four interceptions. Comes in tonight, has two. He didn't play well. He missed targets. But the Bama D.
Oh,
I mean, that's unheard of.
Absolutely unheard of. This defensive backfield, man. It's incredible. What do you got, Colts Chiefs, McShay?
What's that?
What do you got for Colts Chiefs?
You asking for a prediction?
I'm asking for a prediction.
Colts are playing well.
They're playing unbelievable.
Aren't they? Really well. I think they're buying in. Chiefs are obviously better, but
yeah,
they haven't played. They didn't
trust that defense.
No, I'm going to go with the Chiefs, though.
Yeah, home field and plus that offense.
Yeah.
What do you got, Whit?
I got 37-35 Chiefs.
Okay.
I think they put it, they luck goes pound for pound with them. But Mahomes is just that offense.
Get more to
at home. And
Eagles, Saints.
Saints, 25.
I think Saints are really the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Cowboys, Rams.
Yeah.
Cowboys, Rams.
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 Tight.
But Cowboys, though, don't sleep on them now.
No, yeah.
Don't sleep on them. That defense is nasty and
Chargers playing
Jack.
I'm going to go Chargers.
Pat.
I am too.
Yeah, I just got a feeling about it.
Because I picked them in the summer. I got to start with the road.
I think Chargers.
Tight.
Chargers, Saints.
Tight. Number one takeaway from this.
Trevor Lawrence.
Mm-hmm.
True freshman. Poised. Big play. And his man Ross. That kid's ready for the National Football League.
Two more years of college football.
They're going to lose that whole defensive line. They've got some depth behind them. But offensively, they're going to be as good as anyone in the country. I mean, they
agreed.
Are loaded.
One other thing, Dabo Sweeney.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't say enough about who he is, what he's done, what he's built.
Has the tide been turned in college football? Did Clemson just usurp Alabama in terms of the status and power structure of college football?
No.
I know. I hear you.
No
I'm
way.
Throwing it out there.
No
Dabo's
way.
On top of the world. They're the national champions, 44-16.
Go
I got to wrap up the show. Is that okay?
Yeah, sure.
Trevor Lawrence with
347
yards and three touchdowns. Ross had 153 yards receiving and a touchdown. And Clemson are your national championship. Thanks for watching Monday Night Football Film Room with Todd McShay, featuring Todd McShay.